Attention, stations on the network. Our broadcast will begin in 5 minutes from my mark. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, mark. That was your 5 minute time check, stations. Attention, stations on the network. Our broadcast will begin in 2 minutes from my mark. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, mark. That was your 2 minute time check, stations. Attention, stations on the network. Our broadcast will begin in 1 minute from my mark. In 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, mark. That was your 1 minute time check, stations.
The following program is paid for by Learfield Bobcat Sports Properties.
On the Bobcat Sports Network from Learfield, this is Montana State Bobcat Basketball, brought to you by Bridger Brewing. Cheers to every journey being better than the last. Door Tech, raising the door on quality. Montana State University, mountains and minds. And by Prime Lending, home loans made simple, equal housing lender. Live from the First Interstate Bank broadcast booth, here's the voice of the Bobcats, Keaton Gillogly.
It is time to hand out some hardware in Boise. Today, it's Montana State and Montana, the Big Sky Tournament Final. Hello, everybody. My name is Keaton Gillogly. A pleasure to be with you for the final game of the Big Sky Tournament and season, and the winner is moving on to the Big Dance. It's the fifth-seeded Montana State University Bobcats coming in at 16-17 overall after going 9-9 in Big Sky play. On the other side, it's the arch rivals. Number three, the University of Montana. The Grizzlies coming in at 23-10. They went 12-6 during conference action. All right, here we go. Another Big Sky title will be decided in a brawl of the wild for Montana State and Montana. Today, it is the 12th time that these two teams have met in the Big Sky tournament, but just the second time they have met in the title game. Montana State defeated Montana in 1986 for the last title match between these two teams in the tournament. First meeting between these two squads in the conference tournament since 2009, which really does have some pull and some play and some sway in the ball game today. If you remember, that was when they were still playing some of the games at the different teams' sites. And for Montana State, they had struggled against Montana that year. They had gotten beaten fairly convincingly in both of their matchups against the Grizzlies that season. They go over to Boise and they go over to Missoula and they end up beating Montana in 2009 on their way to a finals appearance that season. MSU would lose that championship game in 2009. They'd also lose a championship game in 2021 before they've made the run they have now as the back-to-back champs, looking for a three-peat as they head into their ninth ever tournament final. All right, on the show today, of course, we'll get into our Kendall Ford keys to the game. We're going to sit down with head coach Matt Logie, but first, we're going to get into our Mountain Hot Tub opposing team profile. Time to break down the Montana Grizzlies and see why they're going to be in hot water today, brought to you by Mountain Hot Tub. Mountain Hot Tub is Montana's largest hot tub dealer since 1979. Your authorized hot spring spa dealer with locations in Bozeman, Butte, and Helena. For Montana State and Montana, the two meetings already this year, Bobcats losing both. MSU lost at home 87-77 on January 20th, and then on February 17th, Bobcats lost in Missoula 88-69. Cats kind of hung around a little bit in the first half of that game, but in the end, they ended up trailing by as much as 23 points in the second half against Montana. Anand Moody put up 29 points. Malu Oki had 10 points, 12 rebounds, and Deshaun Thomas had 20 points and 10 rebounds as well. Really, some of the big keys in that game was the offensive rebounding. Montana absolutely smashed the glass in that ballgame. They had 15 offensive rebounds. Oki had 8 of them. That was a big reason why Montana State lost in that game 88-69. The other part of that game in February was Robert Ford III. Really, he kind of struggled in that contest. Remember, he was banged up. That was the game where he took that tough elbow into the rib cage, and that certainly slowed him down. He had 9 points, 8 rebounds, but he went 3 of 10 from the field. You can see he just really wasn't right in that game as things continued. Sam Lekalot had started to come on at that point. He did have 9 points in that contest, but Montana State just kind of didn't have it in Missoula, and that's part of the reason they lost that battle in mid-February over at Dahlberg. So we'll see. Montana State obviously is a much different team now. Garacki struggled in that game with 8 points, going 2 of 5, but he's had a great tournament so far, and we have not had the revelation of John Olmstead quite yet. He only played a minute in that game at the end of the contest against Montana. So Bobcats are a different team now. They obviously have a little bit of a different skill set. They've got a little bit more depth. We'll see for Montana State if that's going to be enough, because this is a Montana team that is very guard heavy. Obviously, you have Josh Vasquez, Brandon Whitney, and Anand Moody, who are all deadly in their own right. Vasquez, the three-point shooter. Anand Moody, another deadly three-point shooter who's got 80 three-point makes. And Brandon Whitney, distributing it all. He comes in at 4.5 assists per game. He's racked up 23 assists in his 6 all-time games against MSU. And Brandon Whitney coming off one of his great Big Sky Tournament performances last night as Montana defeated Idaho State. Whitney had 17 points with 4 assists and no turnovers in that ball game. So those are some of the guys to worry about in the backcourt. In the front court, this is where some of the matchup has been tough for Montana State this year against the Grizzlies. When you look at their 3 big men, Walu Oki, Deshaun Thomas, and Tajon Sawyer, they can all be big contributors on the glass and in the front court. And it was very, very obvious in that first meeting when Deshaun Thomas and Walu Oki each had a couple of double-doubles in that first meeting. So can Montana State clean the glass like they did last night against Sacramento State? Can the Bobcats slow this hot shooting trio of guards down as well? And we'll see. Will it be Montana or Montana State onto the big dance? One of the 2 Treasure State teams will be moving on tonight as we get set for a brawl of the wild between the Bobcats and the Grizzlies with a bid into the NCAA tournament on the line tonight. All right, we're going to take a break. When we come back, we'll take a look at the Kendall Ford keys to the game, and later we'll sit down with head coach Matt Logie. Getting set for Cat Grizz in the Big Sky Tournament Final. It's Montana State and Montana coming up at the bottom of the hour. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
It's the season of home improvement, and Williams Plumbing will help you tackle the big stuff. Are old roots clogging your sewer line? Williams has the tools to fix it. Have you checked your septic system lately? We have the knowledge and experience to maintain or repair it. Looking to install a yard hydrant? We'll do it promptly and professionally. Don't sweat the big stuff. Call Williams Plumbing today.
At Jersey Mike's, watching them freshly slice the meat and cheese for my sub is a sight to behold. The layers of ham, salami, and pepperoni are even more glorious than the pink and orange layers of a sunrise. Yeah, the sun's pretty and all that, but in about 7 billion years, it's going to explode, obliterating the Earth and every living thing on it. And if there's no sun, there's no subs. Meanwhile, the only thing a sub ever obliterated was my hunger. Freshly sliced right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing. A sub above.
Bozeman Spirits Distillery. Craft distilling award-winning spirits for over 9 years. Making some of your favorites like Bobcat Gold Bourbon, Montana 1889 Whiskey, Cold Spring Huckleberry Vodka, Jim Bridger Bourbon, and many more. Visit the tasting room, try signature craft cocktails, and purchase bottles today. Located at 121 West Main, Bozeman Spirits Distillery, downtown Bozeman.
Bobcat fans, support both your favorite team and Montana State students. When you shop at MSU Bookstores, you help lower the price of course materials for Montana State students. MSU Bookstore is owned by MSU students and faculty and serves as the only not-for-profit campus bookstore in Montana. Shop online at msubookstore.org, at Bobcat Stadium on game days, or on campus in the Strand Union Building. Remember, Bobcat fans, when you shop at MSU Bookstore, all proceeds from your purchase go directly to lowering the cost of course materials for Montana State students.
Back on the pregame show, getting set for Montana State and Montana in the Big Sky Tournament Championship. Bobcats are looking to record just the 2nd ever three-peat in the Big Sky Championship. It was Weber State who had done it back in 1978, 79, and 80. So that's the only other time a Big Sky team has racked up 3 straight tournament championships. The Bobcats have a chance to do that today. Also for Montana State, they've won 8 straight in the tournament now. And if they get a win today, that would mark the longest winning streak by any Big Sky team in the tournament. They're trying to break the tie, actually, with Montana, which had won 8 straight from 2018 to 2021. So Montana State not only trying to reach some new heights that they have not been to, but they're trying to reach some seriously rarefied air that any Big Sky team has gotten involved with. And Montana State on the precipice of one of the more memorable nights in program history. All right, let's get into our Kendall Ford keys to the ball game today. A couple of things to look out for in this matchup between the 5th-seeded Bobcats and the third-seeded Grizzlies. First of all, for Montana State, absolutely 100% have to get out to an early lead. This is a Montana team that when they're playing from in front, they play a drastically different style of game. They're much more confident. The shots continue to fall, and they just look like an absolutely, again, different team. So for Montana State, if you can just get out early and get a lead at the start of this game, that is going to make a big-time difference. The other part for Montana State is containing those three guards, Brandon Whitney, Adon Moody, and Josh Vasquez. Can Montana State contain those three and keep them at 35 combined points or fewer? They score 35 or more points. Montana's basically unbeatable at that point, those three guys. It just has to be one or two of them. You know, anytime they're getting up to the mid-30s, closer to 40 points, that trio of guards will power them on to a victory. And then the other part for Montana State is you got to keep hitting shots. MSU has been exquisite from the three-point line in this tournament. If Montana State is going to win this ball game, they're going to do it on the backs of this offense, which has been very strong the last couple of nights. MSU winning the Weber State game in the quarterfinals, winning 91-82. It was the second half that's been the talk of the tournament when they knocked down 75% of their shots, and they went 10 of 14 from the three-point line in that game. Montana State then would come back against Sacramento State and win that one 74-71. Last night, MSU got off to another hot start from the three-point line early in that ballgame. MSU went 8 for 17 in the first half. So you combine those first two, or the last half against Weber State and the first half against Sacramento State, and MSU had knocked down 18 combined threes. So Montana State absolutely has to keep knocking down shots in this one. The offense has been a big reason why they have earned a fourth straight bid into the Big Sky Final. On the other side for Montana, they come in after two fairly convincing wins. So last night they defeated Idaho State 72-58. They had opened up a 20-point lead. Idaho State did cut it to about 9 midway through the second half, but Montana was able to hang on and pull away late as they end Idaho State's really Cinderella run. Idaho State had been the 8 seed coming in, but they get knocked out in the semifinals last night. Before that, Montana got the tournament started for them against Portland State. That was the 3-6 matchup. Montana won that one 87-81. Very offensive second half. Both teams scored 52 points in the second half. Yes, it was just a 6-point game, but really Montana was in pretty comfortable control as that game continued to go on. Anand Moody was great. He had 27 points in that ballgame, and last night it was Brandon Whitney that really led Montana. So that's how both of these teams have gotten here to the Big Sky Tournament Championship, and one team is moving on to the big dance. All right, we're taking another break. When we come back, we'll get you some scores, and later we're sitting down with head coach Matt Logie as we get ready for our Prime Lending tip-off coming up at the bottom of the hour. Montana State and Montana battling for a Big Sky title again tonight. Back after this, you're listening to Bobcat Basketball presented by Learfield.
Discover the difference a family-owned Montana bank can make for you and your business. Stockman Bank is focused only on Montana, no place else. So you come first with us. Enjoy a local banking experience uniquely designed to meet the financial needs of your Montana business. Visit your neighborhood Stockman Bank to say hello and let us earn your trust and your business. Moving Montana forward. Stockman Bank, Montana's brand of banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
For over 100 years, Bozeman Health has provided quality health care in Southwest Montana. With locations in Bozeman, Belgrade, and Big Sky, no matter who you are, where you are, or what you do, Bozeman Health is always there as your partner in health and wellness. Bozeman Health, proud healthcare provider of Bobcat student athletes. Visit bozemanhealth.org for more information.
First West Insurance, a Montana-born company, has been helping friends and neighbors protect what they love most since 1972. From home and businesses to farm and ranch to life and health insurance, our team is dedicated to finding solutions that work for you. We believe in creating relationships as deep as our Montana roots. First West, your local insurance agency.
Everybody in your crew identifies as either Big Mac Burger, McNuggets, or McCrispy Sandwich. but you're the Filet-O-Fish sandwich all day. That crispy fish, that savory tartar sauce, that melty cheese, that pillowy bun. Yeah, you get it. Every time.
Now, BOGO for a dollar has your crew covered with Big Mac, Chicken McNuggets, and Filet-O-Fish. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal. Valid for items equal or lesser value.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Montana Fence, located in Billings, Bozeman, Great Falls, and Kalispell, is Montana's largest fencing superstore. Get everything you need for your fencing projects at rock-bottom pricing. Low prices on all styles of farm fence. Chain link, vinyl privacy, ornamental iron, cedar pickets, continuous panels, wood privacy. We have it all. Quality materials at truckload prices. Let the experts at Montana Fence help you plan your next project. Whether you use our team or do it yourself, check out Montana Fence.
No matter how far you may go, there's always one just down the road.
Town Pump.
Ooh, pump it up.
Pump it up.
Join the Town Pump Fountain and Coffee Club with Pump It Up Rewards. Buy five of any size fountain drink or coffee and get your sixth free. It pays to be a Pump It Up Rewards member. Town Pump, convenient and right down the road.
It is Championship Wednesday in Boise, Montana State and Montana. Just the second ever meeting between these two longtime rivals with the Big Sky Tournament Championship on the line. And what a year it's been for Cat Grizz. Obviously, the Bobcats haven't particularly been on the right side of things in football and basketball so far. But a second meeting this year with a championship on the line, obviously, in Missoula. Cats, if they had won that game in football, they would have won the title. And now today, if the Bobcats get the victory, they will reach rarefied air that has been done just once before in tournament history. Before we get into all of that, it also sounds like our tip time got pushed back a couple of minutes since, the national folks are here and handling that. But that's neither here nor there. First of all, we do want to get to our Wheat, Montana weather report right now. And today it is about 45 degrees in Boise. It'll continue to cool off tonight. We had some rain yesterday, but nice and sunny today. Barely had to wear a coat while I've been here, which has certainly been really, really nice. So great weather, great town, great atmosphere, great environment, and a great round of Bobcats here in the house today. All those fans are basically right behind us, and there are a lot of Bobcats that have come out to support today. So it is a tremendous, tremendous atmosphere at Idaho Central Arena in Boise. And right now, definitely the Montana State fans, a little more hype than the Montana fans. If you're watching on the Behind the Mic presented by Simpkins Holland, you can really see it. I mean, it is four, five sections, and it's a let's go Bobcat chant right now. People love their Bobcats, and they are showing up and showing out. It is a beautiful, beautiful sea of blue and gold in Boise as Montana State tries to continue this incredible run. It's the greatest stretch in Bobcat history right now, no matter what, and we'll see if Montana State can keep this thing rolling, already having won back-to-back Big Sky titles, a chance today for their ninth consecutive tournament win. Montana State, since Danny Sprinkle took over here and going into that 2021 tournament, remember there was the 2020 season was his first year, but that tournament was canceled. But since the 2021 tournament, so in every tournament that has been played in the 2020s here in Boise, Montana State is 10-1 with a pair of titles and a chance for a three-peat today. The only other three-peat was Weber State back in the late 70s. So we'll see if Montana State can bust out those dancing shoes, even though we know those dancing shoes have no dust on them now. All right, taking a look at some other notable scores and moments and other things. So the women's title has already been crowned. It is Eastern Washington off to the big dance today. So they went out and beat earlier here. they defeated Northern Arizona, and they are on to the big dance. NAU had beaten Montana yesterday. So it is Eastern who is the Big Sky regular season and tournament champion today with their victory this afternoon. It was a phenomenal ball game, incredibly entertaining to watch, and Eastern is on their way off to the big dance on the women's side. Also of note, South Dakota State is the Summit League representative in the big dance. They won the regular season and tournament championships. It's just some of the things that are going on right now that we are keeping an eye on as we head through championship week, and Montana State is still here as we get ready for our Prime Lending tip-off coming up at the bottom of the hour. It's number 5, Montana State, and number 3, Montana in the Big Sky Tournament Championship. We're taking a break. When we come back, we will sit down with head coach Matt Logie, and after that, we'll have our starting lineups and tip-off between the Bobcats and the Grizzlies. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
There is a local ranch just outside of Boise, Idaho, that has masterfully bred Japanese Wagyu cattle with American Angus cattle. Now this American-style Wagyu beef is available to you and your family. Rosars presents Snake River American-style Wagyu beef. Snake River Farms beef is famously found in many exclusive five-star steak restaurants. Snake River Farms, available at your local neighborhood Rosars.
When garage door issues happen, don't just call anybody. Call the pros at Door Tech. Our family-owned and operated business happily serves the Gallatin Valley. We install and service residential, commercial, and custom overhead doors and operators. With factory-trained and certified technicians, we're committed to quality, value, and long-term relationships. Call us at 582-1623 and let us help you with the solution to all your garage door needs. Door Tech is raising the door on quality. Your region's only premier authorized Rainer dealer.
It's the season of home improvement, and Williams Plumbing will help you tackle the big stuff. Are old roots clogging your sewer line? Williams has the tools to fix it. Have you checked your septic system lately? We have the knowledge and experience to maintain or repair it. Looking to install a yard hydrant? We'll do it promptly and professionally. Don't sweat the big stuff. Call Williams Plumbing today.
Working from home has definitely put home projects into overdrive. New landscaping, gardens, patios, and fences. But if you're digging, you're contacting 811. Utility lines, including Northwestern Energy's, can be buried even just a few inches underground, and hitting one can be dangerous. The best way to keep you, the community, and your contractor crew safe is by having lines properly marked. Make your request online at least 2 full business days before you want to dig at call811.com.
We're back on the pregame show, Montana State and Montana for the Big Sky Tournament Final. I'm Keaton Gillogly alongside head coach Matt Logie. Coach, here we go, the final game of the tournament. And, you know, as we get ready for this and this run you guys have had, you know, I imagine you're thinking and really relying on your coaching staff and the rest of your staff. There's so much championship experience you have with those guys. What are some of the things you're relying on with them, and how is that playing a role in this tournament run?
Well, I think it's hugely beneficial when you've worked with people in the past. You know, Coach Payne and I have a lot of history in the postseason together. Coach Smith and I have a lot of history together. And then obviously Coach Scholl with his experience, you know, last year at San Diego State and in years prior being a head coach. You know, we have a ton of experience to draw from. And that gives us the ability to stick to our process and continue to, you know, operate in ways that are comfortable for our athletes and you know, just continue to go about doing what's got us here.
Now, you mentioned yesterday in the post-game conversations just about the subtlety of winning championships. What are some of those subtleties that can lead a team to a moment like this?
Well, it's the building of culture, and you know that word is used very loosely oftentimes, but it's a very important concept to winning championships, and it's also a very important concept to building great relationships, and we think those things are tied together. So, you know, our guys have stuck to the process since we got here last spring of you know, building trust with one another, you know, playing for the name on the front of our jersey and loving representing, you know, Montana State University, and developing relationships that are deep and loving towards our teammates and staff, and then being committed to what it takes to be successful, both in the process and also in our response to highs and lows. And then ultimately, you know, being a part of something bigger than yourself means that you're serving the needs of other people. And so those core values have guided us from the day we've got here, and that's going to be what guides us for 40 minutes tonight.
All right, so third game in 3 days, late tip tonight, but just kind of walk us through how you utilized the day. How'd you get these guys ready today, and walk through the scouting report?
Yeah, obviously, all these turnarounds are quick come tournament time, and you're relying on some of the reps and experiences you've had against teams that you've seen before, and that's helpful, certainly, in a situation like this where, you know, when we've played Montana previously this year, we've had one game weeks leading up to those Saturday games, and so that offered a lot of opportunity to practice and prepare. And so you're depositing those reps during the year and able to draw on those today and quickly turn around that prep and have important conversations and have a great shoot around, which we did this morning, and just go about, you know, getting the guys refueled and rested. Obviously a later tip, but you know, you could play this game at 3 a.m. and we'd all show up and be, you know, with bells on. So we're excited about the opportunity, and our guys are more than prepared.
All right, let's get into the X's and O's here. First of all, on the glass, they really Montana did a great job against you guys in that last meeting. What do you guys have to do to be successful against some of the strength and size they have in the front court today?
Yeah, I mean, I think one of the reasons that happened is we broke down in some of our matchup scenarios and ended up in some really unfavorable situations, and if we could be a little bit more disciplined with, you know, our ball screen coverage and some of the other things that led to that, we'll have a little bit more size where we need to have it. And obviously it's a team effort, getting our guards in there and our wings in there to rebound as well. Those are you know, things that we've watched on film and talked about, certainly a great deal.
There are three guards, Vasquez, Moody, and Whitney. What do you guys have to do to slow that trio down today?
Well, it starts in transition with them. Whitney does a really good job of pushing the pace in transition. Obviously, you got Vasquez and Moody that can stretch the floor and shoot it really well in transition. Moody has, you know, about as neon a green light as you're going to find, and so you've got to find him early in transition. And then when it comes to the half court, you just got to be really disciplined with your game plan and how, how you want to defend their screening actions and how you want to defend their ball screens.
Coach, here we go. Championship Wednesday. Good luck today.
Thanks a lot. Go Cats.
All right, we'll take a break. When we come back, we've got starting lineups and tip-off between Montana State and Montana in the Big Sky Tournament Final. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
Join Town Pump's Pump It Up Rewards Plus program and never pay full price for fuel again.
Save 5 cents on every gallon every day at any Town Pump across Montana.
Plus, earn and redeem points on your favorite in-store items to get free stuff with our clubs.
Stop in and pick up a rewards card. Download the Pump It Up Rewards Plus app today.
Or visit townpump.com/rewards to register and start saving.
When your day one proves they're a real one by showing up with McDonald's breakfast before you even get out of bed. The friends don't let friends skip breakfast deal.
Real friends also understand if you eat their hash browns before you even drive back. It's buy one, get one for a dollar at McDonald's with 5 options to mix and match. Sausage McMuffin, burrito, McGriddles, biscuit, or hash browns. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal. Valid for item of equal or lesser value.
At Prime Lending, our one-of-a-kind mortgage approach combines a personal touch with just enough technology to turn a traditionally complex process into something better. Think of us like your home buying coach, friend, cheerleader, and teammate, all in one. From application to closing, we are your home loan partners that have your back every step of the way. Reach out to your local Prime Lending team to experience a home loan made simple. All loans subject to credit approval, rates and fees subject to change. Prime Lending, a Plains Capital Company, NMLS 13649, Equal Housing Lender.
Hello, tomorrow. We may not know exactly what you've got in store for us, for our routines and our normals. But here's the thing. Turns out, we've got this. We haven't seen everything, but we have seen ourselves be more ready for whatever you bring than we thought we would be. So when it comes to tomorrow, bring on the day. First Interstate, built for you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Visit us at firstinterstate.com.
With friendly customer service and an outstanding location near Montana State University in the base of the Bridger Mountain Range, Country Inn & Suites by Radisson is the perfect place to begin your Bozeman adventure. Country Inn & Suites offers a hot and delicious Be Our Guest breakfast buffet each morning. Free Wi-Fi is available throughout the property, and we have a business center and meeting rooms. Our indoor pool and hot tub is a great way to relax after a day of fun, and the on-site fitness center will keep your workout goals on track. We have spacious king and double queen suites with a full-size sleeper sofa available, and every room in Country Inn & Suites is smoke-free. Reserve your room today.
For all of your tree and lawn care needs, turn to Arbor Medic Tree and Lawn Care, a proud sponsor of MSU Athletics. Arbor Medic Tree and Lawn Care provides outstanding service for your landscape for pruning, removals, stump grinding, tree moving, plant health care, and all of your landscaping maintenance needs. Check out Arbor Medic Tree and Lawn Care, Wade Dooley Certified Arborist.
On the Bobcat Sports Network from Learfield, Bobcat Basketball is brought to you by Town Pump Food Stores, proud sponsor of the Brawl of the Wild Series, Guaranteed Rate, the foundation of great homes throughout Montana, and by First Interstate Bank, built for you. Now, turn it up.
Turn it up.
It's game time.
He's got it to the rack. Two-hand slam.
Robert Ford for three.
Got it. Put a stamp on it. You are witnessing the golden age of Bobcat basketball.
Tip-off is just moments away from the First Interstate Bank broadcast booth. Here's the voice of the Bobcats, Keaton Gillogly.
It's a brawl for the right to dance. Montana State University and the University of Montana are ready to square off for the Big Sky Tournament Championship for just the second time in program history. Hello, everybody. My name is Keaton Gillogly. A pleasure to be with you today from Boise, Idaho at Idaho Central Arena, typically a hockey arena, but since 2019, this has been the site of the Big Sky Tournament Championship and the tournament. And for Montana State, they have had wild success in this building, more success than they have had at any point in time in program history. And for MSU today, eyeing a sixth bid into the NCAA tournament, and it would be their third in the last 3 years. So they've got their sights set on a three-peat, but standing in their way is the arch rival, the other side of the fifth most played rivalry in college basketball. It's Montana State and Montana today. It's the 308th meeting all time. It's the 12th meeting between these two teams in the tournament. Montana State is 5-6 against the Grizzlies in the tournament. They did win the most recent meeting back in 2009, which has a few similarities to this one. Montana State beating Montana in Missoula back in 2009, back when teams still were the host site, and Montana State really struggled in that game, or excuse me, in that season against Montana. They had lost both of their regular season matchups against the Grizzlies. They go over to Missoula. They get an early lead. It wasn't much, but they found a way to hang on and beat Montana that day. So, can the Bobcats today relive some of that after really not playing well in the matchups earlier this year? MSU lost by 10 at home. They were down by more than 20 on the road against Montana in the second meeting, and we'll see if the Bobcats can handle some business today. And two lifelong friends and a mentor and mentee meet at center court. It is first-year head coach Matt Logie, although in his 13th year overall, and the 10th-year head coach of the University of Montana, Travis DeCure. Those two guys both growing up in the same area in Seattle. Travis DeCure played for Coach Logie's grandfather while Logie was a ball boy on that high school team. And then while Logie was playing for his grandfather, it was DeCure that was an assistant on that team in high school basketball. And now all those years later, here we are in Boise for the 2024 championship. And those two guys are squaring off tonight for a right to go to the NCAA tournament. For MSU, they have found wild success here. They are 10-1 in Boise in the tournament since 2021. That was the first year under Coach Sprinkle. The only loss was the championship game in 2021. And remember, for Montana State, when you really just think about how special this run has been over the last couple of years, I know I don't need to remind many people of this, but from 2001 until 2019, in the 17 tournament games the Cats had then, they were just 3-14. However, one of those three wins was against this Montana program. So, we'll see. Bobcats try to find some success against the Grizzlies today. All right, here we go. Let's get through the starting lineups now. Montana is the home team today. They are in the white uniforms. Montana written in maroon across the chest with maroon numbers on the front and the back and a script Grizzly written on the bottom of the shorts. For the Bobcats, back in the navy blues after taking down number 10 Sacramento State yesterday in the semifinals. Bobcats are the 5 seed, looking to get back to 500 overall this year at 16-17. Montana is 23-10 overall. They are 12-6 in conference play. They had a chance to finish in one of those top two seeds. They eventually ended up as the 3 seed. So the starting lineups for the visiting Montana State Bobcats. Same starting lineup we have seen throughout most of the year. The point guards are Robert Ford III, one of the leading candidates for tournament MVP. Eddie Turner is the fellow point guard. Tyler Patterson is one of the wings, along with Brian Garacki. And finally, in the front court, it is Brandon Walker. That is the starting five for Montana State. On the other side, for 10th-year head coach Travis DeCure and the Montana alum, his starting lineup looks like this, as it has pretty much all year long. This is one of the more experienced teams across the conference. And their starting lineup has Josh Vasquez in the backcourt, along with the point guard Brandon Whitney. The three-point sharpshooter is Anan Moody. And in the front court, Lalu Oki and Deshaun Thomas. It was Oki and Thomas that dominated the Bobcats in Missoula on February 17th. They both posted double-doubles. And we'll see if Montana State, which has found much more success in the front court recently, can find some success against those two guys today, because that was a part of what was really a bad matchup for Montana State. We'll see if they can reverse the trend today. Now you hear the Bobcat fans behind us who are getting excited and ready to go. You know, it's one of those things where you, when you're living in the good old days, you hope to know that you are and recognize it in the moment. And let me tell you, Bobcat fans, these right now, this year, this is the good old days for Montana State basketball. And they're going to try to keep this march going on tonight against their arch rivals. They are getting ready now to announce the starting lineup for Montana State. They have just played the highlight video, and they are about to send their starting five out. For Montana State, their road to the championship final today. It began with a win against Weber State, which was one of the more impressive shooting performances for Montana State all year long. The Bobcats hung 66 points in the second half. In the quarterfinals on Monday, they knocked down 10 three-point field goals, and they shot 75% from the field in the second half alone. And that game, that half, has been the talk of the tournament. Nobody can believe what Montana State did in that second half against Weber State. And part of it was the 14 straight field goal makes that Montana State had during what was essentially the game-clinching run to end the great Dylan Jones' career in the Big Sky. After that, they had the other side of the Cinderella story. Number 10 Sacramento State was the team that had the honor of upsetting number 1 Eastern Washington in the quarterfinals. It's the second straight year in which Eastern Washington has been one and done in the tournament after being the regular season champs. And so Sacramento State, which is much improved, goes on, and they lose yesterday to Montana State. The Bobcats yesterday had a real hot shooting start in the first half of the ball game. They had built out a 14-point lead late in the first half, and then that's when Sac State made their run. They had a long 11-0 run right after the Bobcats had built up their largest lead, but MSU got some clutch free throws from Jed Miller down the stretch. Sam Lekalot posted his second career double-double, and Montana State was able to dispatch the Cinderella and send Sacramento State home packing and get their fourth straight berth into the Big Sky Final. It was also Montana State's fifth straight win in the semifinals and overall their eighth straight win in the tournament. That is tied with Montana for the longest Big Sky tournament winning streak in the history of the conference. This tournament dates back to 1976, approaching 50 years of Big Sky Tournament basketball. On the other side, the path to the championship game for the University of Montana. They were in contention for that two seed, but they ended up finishing number three with a 12-6 conference record. They came out against the Portland State team, which had beaten Montana pretty handily earlier this year, and they won that game 87-81. Anand Moody had 27 points in the game. They fouled that up against the other Cinderella, Idaho State, the number eight seed in the tournament, and they dispatched the Bengals quite quickly, winning 72-58. All right, here we go. Trevor Nominuk is our producer today. I am Keaton Gillogly. A true treat to be with you in what is one of the great runs in program history. You can soak it all in right now and enjoy this one as Montana State, the first year under Coach Logie, is trying to get back to the big dance for a third consecutive season. Montana State in the Navy Blues, Montana in the home whites, the third meeting this year between these two teams, the 12th in the tournament, and the 308th all-time in a series that dates back to 1902, and one of the more storied games in this storied rivalry that's over 120 years old will begin now. Lalu Oki, Brandon Walker at center court, and we are ready to go for our Prime Lending tip-off. The ball is tossed in the air, and the tip is won by the Montana Grizzlies. Here we go for the 2024 Big Sky Tournament Championship. Montana has the basketball to begin. They work offensively to our left. Brandon Whitney throws it to Moody, back up to Whitney and around to Oki. One of the more experienced teams in the Big Sky. You're going to recognize all these names if you followed Big Sky basketball recently. Moody bounces to the free throw line. Whitney has to back it out. Whitney steps up for a long two, rimming, no. Oki offensive rebound, but they're calling a foul. That foul will go on. Now they're both 21. I think it's Brian Garacki, and it is for displacing Oki while he was in the air. So there you go. That was an offensive rebound by Montana. That was a part of the issue for Montana State in the meeting in Missoula when Montana had 15 offensive rebounds. Second crack at it here for Montana. Around into the post. Oki up. Blocked foul. Yep. Tyler Patterson got the hand on it. First foul on Patterson. So one possession, one offensive rebound, two fouls. And Lalu Oki will go to the stripe. Lalu Oki, the second-year player here at Montana after playing 4 years at the D2 level. He had the big game on February 17th in Missoula with the double-double. Knocks down the first free throw. Fresh nets after they were cut down by Eastern Washington. The women's program for Eastern Washington heading off to the NCAA tournament after they beat Northern Arizona in the final earlier this afternoon. Oki misses the second free throw. Brandon Walker has the rebound, and Montana State has their first offensive possession of the evening. MSU working to our right. Brandon Walker has it at the top, takes it to the mid-post, spins into the lane, goes up with the left hand, too strong off the glass, missed it, and Montana has the rebound. Whitney streaking into the front court, slows down at the top. Gives it to the left wing for Moody. He's on the drive, gets underneath, pivoting, doubled, hands it off for Oki, goes up and flushes it home with two hands. 3 points for Lalu Oki, off to a hot start today. He has not done a ton in the tournament. He's off to a good start now. 3-0 lead for the Grizzlies, 18:45 to go in the first half. Eddie Turner with the ball. He's on a drive down to the left block, puts up a floater, rimming, no, and the Cats begin 0-2 from the field. Cats are going to need their offense if they're going to pull off this victory today. Moody with the dribble out of the left wing. Takes it down into the mid post. He goes to the rack. Blocked from behind. Tyler Patterson got a piece of it. MSU with a rebound. They push the tempo from left to right. Robert Ford fires into the corner. Garacki for three. Yes. 3-point shooting has been the engine of the Bobcat postseason run. Brian Garacki knocks down the first long range attempt of the night for MSU. We got a tie game 3-3. 18 minutes to go, first half of the tournament championship. Into Whitney, cutting to the rack, kicks to the right corner. Deshaun Thomas for three. He airballed it, came up short. Brandon Walker has the rebound. Walker across the timeline, takes it up to the top of the key to get organized. He crosses over, had his pocket picked from behind, able to recover the loose ball. Gives to Garacki in the left corner, and it's tipped out of bounds, staying with Montana State. 17:48 to go in the first half, just settling in. 3-3 between the Cats and the Grizzlies. From the left sideline, Robert Ford III will inbound in the Bobcat offensive zone. Ford gives it into Eddie Turner on the left wing. Back to Ford at the top. Ford crossing over into the lane, hops on the mid post, puts it up off the glass and in. Spinning it off the window, Robert Ford III into the score sheet early, his first 2 points. Montana State up 5-3, 17:34 to go in the first half. It is paramount that Montana State plays from in front early tonight. Moody down to the left elbow, fires out to the top of the key. Josh Vasquez around the screen, pulls up at the elbow. His jumper is short. Robert Ford with the rebound. MSU from left to right after the stop. Ford to the left wing with the bounce. Steps up, tries a three. That got blocked. Deshaun Thomas came out and got a hand on it. Montana pushing the other way. Whitney tapers off on the right wing. Up to Moody. Tried a three, knocked free by Turner. Moody able to recover. Cats doing a nice job closing out on Moody. Hand off to Oki. Yeah, bobbles, recovers, gets into the lane, goes up, contest by Patterson, no good. Great defense by Tyler Patterson. Brandon Walker with a rebound. Montana State the other way. Ford out of the left wing. Hands it off. Patterson trailing. His three, short, just a little too deep. And Montana with a rebound. Quiet shooting start for MSU. 2 of 6 from the field, 1 of 3 from downtown. MSU up 5-3. 16:35 to go in the first half. We got a whistle. Oh, and a blocking foul. Brandon Whitney going into Robert Ford. I don't know about that. I'm not really sure where you would say he wasn't in the correct guarding position. He looked squared. He looked right. I mean, it looked like a shoulder right into his chest. But he did not get the call. First foul on Ford. So, little something to keep an eye on here. Garacki, Ford, and Patterson all with one foul in the first couple of minutes. A couple of subs now. So it's Turner, Olmstead, Lekalot, Patterson, and Ford on the floor for MSU. Vasquez looking to inbound. He finds Tajon Sawyer, who just checked in. Sawyer against Olmstead. Sawyer has to throw it out to the top of the key. Sawyer-Olmstead matchup is going to be one to keep an eye on. Whitney on the drive to the mid post. Stops, leans in, puts it up, whistle. Oh, and they called a foul on Eddie Turner. Turner was going straight up. Whitney clearly extended the arm, and Turner picks up his foul, first foul. So that'll send Brandon Whitney to the line. That is two, at best, questionable foul calls that Brandon Whitney has drawn against Montana State. I really thought he extended the arm there. Logie's going to get an explanation. He's mimicking exactly what we were just talking about, that extended arm while he was in the air. And Whitney hits the first free throw where he's an 82% shooter. Brandon Whitney, a 4-year starter, playing in his 120th game. Also, Tyler Patterson today playing in his 127th to tie Harold Frey for the program record. Brandon Whitney splits the free throws. MSU the other way. Turner to the mid post. Kicks out to Robert Ford. Ford behind the back dribble. Nearly lost it. Recovers. Gives to Olmstead at the point. Hand off for Patterson coming off the screen. He drives. Takes an elbow jumper. And it's good. Tyler Patterson pouring it home. Tyler Patterson has been to the championship game of the tournament every year that he has played in one. And he's trying to go back to his third NCAA tournament. MSU up 7-4. 16 minutes to go. First half. Deshaun Thomas at the top. Pivoting, fires and picked. Robert Ford with a steal, whistled a foul on Anon Moody. Robert Ford III, his 96th steal, a program record, the most in a single season by a Bobcat. MSU with a little momentum as we head to our first time out of the Big Sky Tournament Championship. 15 minutes, 45 seconds to go in the first half. Montana State 7, Montana 4. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball presented by Learfield.
Hello, tomorrow. We may not know exactly what you've got in store for us, for our routines and our normals. But here's the thing. Turns out, we've got this. We haven't seen everything, but we have seen ourselves be more ready for whatever you bring than we thought we would be. So when it comes to tomorrow, bring on the day. First Interstate, built for you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Visit us at firstinterstate.com.
First West Insurance, a Montana-born company, has been helping friends and neighbors protect what they love most since 1972. From home and businesses to farm and ranch to life and health insurance, our team is dedicated to finding solutions that work for you. We believe in creating relationships as deep as our Montana roots. First West, your local insurance agency.
The Northern Pulse Growers Association encourages industry professionals and growers of dry peas, chickpeas, lentils, and fava beans to become members in 2024. Members gain access to cutting-edge research, expert training, market insights, and connect with a Pulse passionate community. Visit northernpulse.com to join the Northern Pulse Growers Association. Together, we're sowing the seeds of success.
Back at First Interstate Bank broadcast position, Montana State is leading Montana 7-4 in the Big Sky Tournament Championship. 15 minutes, 45 seconds to go in the first half. And for the Bobcats, a very strong start defensively. I think a lot of the talk and the focus has been if Montana State's going to win this game, they're going to have to do it on the backs of their offense. They've been shooting the ball so well, but I think the counterpoint to that is, look, yeah, MSU has shot the ball otherworldly in the Big Sky Tournament, but I don't know that you can totally rely on that and keep shooting at as high a level as they have. So far, MSU has done a very good job on the glass, on the defensive side. Not something we could say about the first two meetings between these two teams. Hello, Daniel Sally. Hello, Eric Denson tuned in. Daniel Sally, a smart man. He's got the Varsity Network app, and he has used that to sync the game up with the national broadcast. MSU with the ball. They lead 7-4. Alley-oop. Olmstead missed it. Just a little bit too high. It slipped out of his hands, and Montana has the loose ball. That one would have been a big one. Whitney up at the top comes left around a screen. Fires up to Sawyer. Hand off to Moody. It got tipped. He recovers. Moody to his left, trying to turn the corner. He is draped defensively. Fired to Sawyer. He's in the lane, working on Olmstead. Turns, hook, shot, no. Lekalot fighting for the rebound. Out of bounds, Bobcat basketball. MSU is absolutely drowning Anand Moody right now. Don't know if it's going to keep up. He's an electric player. We all understand that. But Montana State right now is giving Moody absolutely zero room to breathe. If MSU's going dancing, they're going to have to keep that up for 40 minutes. Much easier said than done. 15 minutes, 15 seconds to go in the first half of the Big Sky Tournament Championship. MSU looking for their Big Sky record, ninth straight win in tournament play. Eddie Turner gives it to John Olmstead. He hands it off for Robert Ford III, the heart and soul. Toss out to Lekalot. To the elbow, works inside. He tries to kick out the pass. It got tipped. Olmstead recovers. Thrown to Turner. He's moving inside, picks up the dribble, bounce pass underneath. Olmstead with five to shoot, hooks it up, no. Lekalot, an offensive rebound, and he comes out of traffic with it. He'll reset the Bobcat offense. Hand off for Robert Ford III. Out on the left wing with MSU up by three. Ford on the drive, he's doubled, picks it up, shovel pass to Lekalot. Left wing three, that's short. Rebound, tipped, loose. Ford wins the 50-50 ball on the floor. We've got a whistle, timeout or jump ball. No signal. Jump ball. So we'll stay with Montana State. 14 minutes, 29 seconds to go in the first half. Bobcats are leading 7-4 against the Grizzlies in what has begun as a defensive battle, which is not what people would have bet on coming into this game. Eddie Turner ready to inbound from the baseline. Plenty of time on the shot clock. Turner looking to get it in, and he finds Lekalot with a contested catch on the left sideline. Given to Ford, around to Turner on the right wing. Turner moves left around a screen, gets into the paint, kicks it out. Patterson steps to his left. He lets it fly. Short on the three-point attempt. Montana with a rebound. Neither team clicking offensively yet. Whitney into the lane, kicks it out. Throws to Vasquez in the left corner. Josh Vasquez, the program leader in games played. Throws up to Jordan Williams, one of the newcomers. Out to Brandon Whitney, the four-year starter. Given to Lalu Oki, the second-year player in a transfer. Hand off to Moody, the seventh year. Tries the three, left it short. Olmstead had the contest, and Lekalot had the rebound. He throws ahead. Olmstead cherry-picking, two-hand jam. Timeout, Montana. John Olmstead in transition. The big-time flush. And MSU has a 9-4 lead with 13:51 to go in the first half. The Bozeman Come On In Hotel and Suites is a proud sponsor of MSU Athletics and the Montana State Alumni Association. The Come On In allows you to escape the ordinary while enjoying their numerous hotel and guest room amenities. Visit comeonin.com to book your stay today. We also remind you that Bobcat Basketball is presented by your locally owned McDonald's restaurants. Download the app and earn free food. Order from anywhere and even skip the line with convenient curbside pickup. All assists are sponsored by Aware Mental Health Services. Heck of a dive by Robert Ford III with a home run ball, and John Olmstead turning it into 2 points with a big two-hand slam. Remember, Olmstead was not a factor at all in the first two meetings, but he has been one of the main factors down the stretch for Montana State, which is trying to win their fourth consecutive game. They are on their hottest heater of the year, and there's no better time to do it. And when you're in March, 13:50 to go, first half of the Big Sky Tournament Final. MSU leads the arch-rival Montana Grizzlies 9-4. Whitney guarded by Ford. Oh, that's a pesky fight. Whitney into the lane. Kicks it out to Thomas. Thrown around to Vasquez. He gets an open three, and it's good. You knew that one was good as he loaded up for it with nobody in his face. 41% from downtown. Josh Vasquez with his first three of the day. Cats up two. Ford on the drive. Pulls up. An offensive foul. Not on Ford. Okay, it was on Olmstead. Olmstead with a moving screen, his first. Okay, that makes more sense. That's a big call, too, because if it had been on Ford, it would have been his second. But it's all good. Olmstead with his first. Cats are on the precipice of foul trouble with Garacki, Ford, Olmstead, Patterson, and Turner all with a single foul. Whitney with a dribble out in the left corner. Bobcats leading by two. 13 minutes, 14 seconds to go in the first half. Whitney fires to the top, around to Moody on the right wing. Into the right corner, Thomas, back to Moody. He tries to drive, gets into the paint, pump fake, leans in, floater is good. Moody's having to work hard. His first 2 points today. He had 27 in the quarters, 12 points in the semis yesterday. We got a tie game, 19 points apiece, 13 minutes to go in the first half. Olmstead at the top, one dribble, hands it off on the right wing. Eddie Turner behind a screen, he triggers a three. Missed it right. Rebound tip. Lekalot won it. Beat Deshaun Thomas for it. MSU gets another crack at it. Turner to his right. Alley-oop. Olmstead makes the catch and jams it home. John Olmstead, the former four-year walk-on on Arizona State, putting an exclamation point on his career. Moody, quick trigger right wing three, and it's good. Oh, man, you just can't give Moody any rays of light. Didn't have much space, but it was enough. Grizzlies back on top, 12-11. 12 minutes to go in the first half. Olmstead, a drive and a pass out, tip free and out of bounds along the baseline. It is still Montana basketball. Phenomenal crowd. Not a sellout. Definitely not a sellout. But the upper deck across from us at the scorers table, mostly full. The lower bowl over there on that side, very full. Right behind us, absolutely jam-packed. All for a 9:30 Wednesday night tip. Cats inbound in their own offensive zone. Lekalot has it, and he gives to Olmstead. He got whacked, no call. Olmstead hands off to Garacki. He dials up a three, short. Rebound Montana. Cats a quiet start, 1 of 7 from downtown. Moody probing on the right wing. Hands off for Vasquez, pivoting beyond the arc. Jump pass to Oki. Picks up the dribble. Fires into the corner. Moody tries a three. That's no good. Garacki the rebound. MSU outstanding on the glass today. Out rebounding the Grizzlies. 12-8 to start. MSU down one with the ball. Ford crossing over. He's left open. His three ball? No. Too strong. And the rebound grabbed by Montana. MSU really starting to settle for some threes now. Half their shots have been from downtown. Whitney on the drive. Gets inside. Hands it off. Floater up. No. Put back. Yes. Oki able to finish. He's had a hot hand early with 5 points. Grizzlies up 14-11. 11 and a quarter to go in the first half of the Big Sky Tournament Championship. Olmstead at the top, moving right. Hands it off for Patterson. He takes it down to the right baseline. Throws back out to Olmstead. Picks up the dribble. Needs to get rid of it. Pivoting and gives it to Patterson with 10 to shoot. Patterson turns, pulls up at the free throw line, and the jumper is good. That is just what the doctor ordered. Tyler Patterson pouring it in from the free throw line. That mid-range game for him can be absolutely deadly. Patterson's two takes MSU back to within one. Montana 14, Montana State 13. 10:40 to go, first half. Oki at the top, fires into the left corner. Vasquez for three. Yep. All the talk this tournament has been about Montana State's shooting. But this Grizzlies team has been filled with sharpshooters in Boise. This one knocked out of bounds, staying with Montana State, and that will take us to a timeout. Now the first quarter of this game has delivered. It's the Big Sky Tournament Championship. somebody from the Treasure State is going dancing. 10 minutes, 22 seconds to go in the first half. Montana State trailing Montana 17-13. Back to the First Interstate Bank broadcast position after this. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball presented by Learfield.
Are you too hot? Are you too cold? Did you know that you don't have to just deal with it? We at Ambient Air Solutions understand how important comfort plays on your emotions, health, and quality of life on a daily basis. Ambient Air Solutions offers 24/7 emergency service for residential and commercial clients. We also offer financing to help ease the financial stress and burden of a lifelong investment. Call Ambient Air Solutions at 406-577-1818 and leave it to the professionals. Ambient Air Solutions, simplifying heating and cooling.
The snow is falling and temps are dropping, Bobcat fans, so it's the perfect time to cozy up with heartwarming soups and comfort food. Elevate your kitchen game and create magic tonight with La Cuisine's premium cookware. Don't forget the secret ingredient, a new top-selling cookbook. Attend a cooking class and you'll learn how to make every meal a slam dunk. La Cuisine is Bozeman's boutique kitchen store, and we can help you create the perfect table with our curated Montana-made and European dining treasures. Discover the ideal blend of style and functionality at La Cuisine, 2405 West Main.
Loaded tortilla soup is back at Qdoba. Savory veggie broth packed with flavor from tomatoes, peppers, onions, and spices. Enjoy loaded tortilla soup in a bowl or crunchy tortilla shell with your favorite protein and craveable toppings. That's right, the soup sensations fans have been raving about has returned. But not for long, so get it while it's hot. Loaded tortilla soup is back at Qdoba. Order today at Qdoba.com or in the app.
We're back to First Interstate Bank broadcast position. Montana State trailing Montana 17-13. 10 minutes, 22 seconds to go in the first half of the Big Sky Tournament Championship. Well, the Sacramento State mascot is still here. He is wearing rolled-up jeans, and he's got his Starch Madness shirt on with his stingers sticking out the back. Yeah, we appreciate that. We assume that the Hornet is rooting for the Bobcat. There's no way a Hornet would root for a Grizzly. No chance. All right, before the Cats inbound, let's pause 10 seconds for our network station identification. You're listening to Montana State Basketball.
AM 1450 KMMS, Bozeman. 1340 KPRK Livingston, where Montana talks.
Bobcats inbounding, trailing 17-13 against the Grizzlies. 10:19 to go in the first half of the Big Sky Tournament Championship. Ford probes, kicks it out to Lekalot, around to Patterson, and then to Olmstead in the right corner. Shovel pass to the top for Patterson. Seven to shoot. Patterson back to Olmstead. Five. He gives it to Ford. Four. He tries to contest it. Three and drills it. That's how you build an MVP case right there. Robert Ford the third. 5 points. Hoping this ain't his last game in the blue and gold. Montana State trailing 17-16. 9:50 to go first half. Oki at the top for the Grizzlies. To our left of the home whites into the post. Whitney slip free. Easy lay-in. Mistake by the Bobcat offense, or excuse me, defense rather. Whitney with 3 points. MSU down three with the ball, 9:35 to go first half. Ford steps back, kicks to the left wing for Lekalot. Throws to Olmstead at the top. Handoff for Garacki. Dribbles right, gets a mismatch, gets to the mid post, draws a double team, kicks it out. Olmstead, one dribble, picks up the dribble on the left wing, gives it to Ford. Alley-oop, Olmstead makes the catch and rips the rim home. What a pass by Rob Ford and John Olmstead. Stepping up big, 6 points. And Montana State down by one. These two teams starting to trade blows now. Whitney to the free throw line for Oki. Kick out Vasquez. Bobbles and recovers near the half court line. 9 minutes to go in the first half. Moody up to the top. Picks up the dribble. Bounce to Oki. Goes up. Foul. Lekalot with a foul. Oki missed the dunk. Lekalot's first. Oki went down hard. He's going to the line. Pretty straight up. Kind of brought the arms down. Take a look at the replay. No, they're showing that Olmstead dunk. So Lalu Oki is going to the line. And Logie is getting the explanation. Meanwhile, I remind you that it's a new season at Kohl's with everyday styles at great prices. You can get more of what you want for less, for go-tos, for going everywhere, and perfect picks for your home. Shop Kohl's and Kohl's.com today. Oki taking an extra beat. He came down hard on his tailbone. Moody working the official over on the right wing as well. Oki knocks down the free throw. Okie, 63% from the free throw line. Turner and Walker in, Olmstead and Ford out. So it's Turner, Walker, Patterson, Lekalot, Garacki. On the other side, Whitney, Moody, Vasquez, Thomas, Okie. Okie looking to extend the Grizzlies' lead. Free throw's good. He hits them both. 21-18, Grizzlies leading, 8:51 to go in the first half. MSU eyeing their sixth NCAA tournament. Looking for the three-peat in Boise. Place the Bobcats have basically built now. They've played in four of the five tournament finals hosted in Boise. Brandon Walker down to the right baseline. He draws a double. Now they come off him. He goes up with the right hand, lays it. No, but they draw the foul. Dejon Sawyer picks up his first. So they kind of came down and helped defensively and then backed off. And it does look like they're going to call a lot in the post. So looks like it's going to be very, very difficult to kind of stay straight up. Sawyer, that was not a particularly, egregious foul, but neither was Sam Lekalot. So consistent and something you're going to need to be aware of now. Walker misses the first free throw. Serving all your garage door needs, DoorTech is raising the door on quality. 8:38 to go in the first half. Bobcats trailing 21-18, but a chance at the free throw line for Brandon Walker, looking for his first point of the day. The shot is no good. He missed them both. Oh, you cannot be missing free throws in a championship game. Montana into the front court. Whitney on the drive into the mid post. Reverses direction, goes to his right, lays it up. Ooh, what a finish. Little floater over the extended hand of Eddie Turner, who had a tough contest. Dangerous spot now. 5-point lead for the Grizzlies. 8.25 to go in the first half. Cats need a bucket. Walker throws out to the right wing for Turner. Back to Walker, right baseline. Posting up against Thomas. Spins to the left shoulder, goes up through contact, able to finish. Brandon Walker, his first 2 points of the day. And Montana State back to within three, 7:55 to go in the first half. Whitney on the drive into the lane, kicks it out. Here's Sawyer, handoff for Vasquez, met by Turner. Up to Whitney at the top of the key. Whitney to the free throw line, pulls up the mid-range. J is pure. Brandon Whitney, the four-year senior starter. He has been electric in the tournament, and he's had a hot start tonight. He's got seven. MSU down five, 7:30 to go, first half. Cats with the ball to our right. Walker, topside three. That is no good, and Montana State is just 2 of 10 from beyond the arc today. Montana with the ball to our left. Rob Ford will check in the next stoppage. Whitney looking for the post, doesn't have it. Lekalot down there battling against Thomas. Whitney with the dribble to the right wing. To the free throw line on Patterson. On the drive, lays it up. No, and Lekalot has the rebound, and then it gets fouled by Jackson Knapp from behind. Sam Lekalot, high motor kid, showing it off in the post right now. It's all hanging in the balance of the Big Sky Tournament Championship. We're taking a break from the First Interstate Bank broadcast position. 7 minutes, 4 seconds to go in the first half. Montana leading Montana State 25-20. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball presented by Learfield.
For every peak, valley, and plateau, for every mishap and every adventure, for every Montanan in every season of life, Bozeman Health is here to deliver care with quality, compassion, and respect. Because we see you as more than the patient you are today, we look to what's on the horizon for you and our community over the decades to come. That's care beyond care. Well beyond. Bozeman Health.
All right, team, bring it in. We have 5 minutes left on the clock. We got to show them what we're made of.
Woohoo! Yeah!
We need to focus. Every save counts, especially when it comes to fill-ups at Conoco.
What? Coach?
We're going to go back out there and save money when we fill up with the Fuel Forward app. So anytime from this day forward, whenever we're at a Conoco, we're going to use that app. Bring it in. Conoco on three. One, two, three.
Conoco!
Let's go, Cats. Download the Fuel Forward app and save with every fill-up at Conoco. Proud sponsor of the Montana State Bobcats.
With friendly customer service and an outstanding location near Montana State University and the base of the Bridger Mountain Range, Country Inn & Suites by Radisson is the perfect place to begin your Bozeman adventure. Country Inn & Suites offers a hot and delicious Be Our Guest breakfast buffet each morning. Free Wi-Fi is available throughout the property, and we have a business center and meeting rooms. Our indoor pool and hot tub is a great way to relax after a day of fun, and the on-site fitness center will keep your workout goals on track. We have spacious king and double queen suites with a full-size sleeper sofa available, and every room in Country Inn & Suites is smoke-free. Reserve your room today.
Not only is dairy delicious, but it promotes health as well. Just 3 servings of dairy a day improves overall wellness and may reduce the risk of developing some chronic diseases. It's a quick, convenient, and economic way to make sure you are staying strong and healthy on and off the field. It's the Big Sky Tournament Championship. Montana State looking to go dancing, but they got to get through the rivals tonight. Grizzlies leading the Bobcats 25-20, 7:04 to go in the first half. A lot of offense lately after a slow offensive start. Grizzlies have hit 5 of their last 6 shots. Bobcats have hit 4 of their last 5. But MSU, after shooting the lights out from 3 the last 2 nights, are just 2 of 10 from downtown. Sponsored, of course, by Wendy's. Montana 3 of 6 from beyond the arc. Battle on the glass even at 12 rebounds apiece. That's a very good sign for Montana State. Like a lot getting a quick piece of advice from the official. Lekalot seems to be appreciating the conversation, nodding his head yes. And now we are ready to go. Inbound to Eddie Turner, who takes it into the front court and hands off for Tyler Patterson. Cats down 5 with the ball in the championship. Hand off for Walker at the top. Crosses over on Oki, gets down to the left block, leans in, pump fake, up, lays it in. Wow. Brandon Walker by himself, right to the rack. Thought he was a big man. That looked like a guard. Great play by Walker. Cats back within 3. Montana with a basketball. Grizzlies working at the top. It's Brandon Whitney against Patterson. Bounce to the right wing for Thomas. Posting up on the right wing. Trying to back it in. Gets a little help defensively. Turn, whistle, and a travel. Rob Ford came over with a help defense with Sam Lekalot. And that helped force the travel and the turnover. Clean game so far. 1 turnover apiece. Make that the second for the Grizzlies, that last one. Ford was hyped up. One of the great stories that have come out of the tournament here the last couple of days, Rob Ford tempering the celebrations in the locker room the last 2 days. He's been all business. He wants at least 1 more in the blue and gold. Turner down to the right block. Turn, floater, up, no. Missed it off the glass. Montana the rebound. Moody takes it across the timeline. Coming left to the wing. Comes back to his right. Hand off for Vasquez, met by Ford. Vasquez backing it out, picks up the dribble, gives to Moody, guarded by Lekalot, drives to the free throw line, kicks it out. Vasquez tries a 3, rimming, no, tip for the rebound, and Montana State comes away with it. Ford, without numbers, into the front court, goes against Whitney, brings it back out, turns, mid-range jumper, and it's good. Automatic, Robert Ford the 3rd. 7 points for Ford. Cats back within 1. Rob's got that look in his eye. Oh, look out. Whitney over to the left wing. Throws to Oki at the top. Fires into the post. Bad pass, turned it over. Lekalot was helping to deny Josh Vasquez, who was cut into the rack. And that helped that bad pass out of bounds. 5:33 to go in the first half. Montana State trailing 25-24. It has been tight to this point. Both teams have had a 5-point lead. That's as large as it has been on either side. MSU with the ball to our right. Garacki at the top. Hand off for Walker. Given to Ford. Ford takes it to the left wing. Crosses over on Vasquez. Behind the back dribble. Jump pass out to the left corner. Turner. 7 to shoot. Turner on the drive. Kicks it out to Walker at the top 5. He tries a deep 3. No. Rebound tipped. 1 by Montana. Grizzlies from right to left. John Olmstead getting ready to check back in. Whitney on the left wing. Bent over the bounce. Grizzlies leading by 1. Toss to Oki at the free throw line. His pass not free, but recovered by Montana. Back up to Oki at the top. Guarded tightly by Walker. Now into the rack. A rack attack blocked and fouled. Garacki picked up his 2nd. You basically just can't contest at the rim right now. They're going to call every piece of contact at the rim. Looked like a lot of ball. Looked like a pretty straight up jump. And the official explaining that he jumps into Oki. And if that's what he saw, then that's the right call. Tough part about that is it's Garacki's 2nd. Yeah, it was not the contact up top. It was not the ball. It was the jumping into him and having the body contact. Oki at the free throw line came up short. InterWest Moving and Storage is the official moving company of the MSU Bobcats. MSU has titles in 1986. A win over Montana in that one to go to the NCAA tournament. A win in 1996 in Bozeman. Danny Sprinkle, the 30-point game. And titles in 2022 and 2023 here in Bozeman. Will we add 2024 to the fire? Oki at the line. Knocks down the second free throw. Lalu Oki making a living at the stripe. He's got 8 total points. Montana State down 2 with the ball. 4:40 to go first half. Turner gives it to Lekala. Hands off for Patterson at the top of the key. He pulls up. A contested 3 is no good. Fight for the rebound. Oh, they just called a foul on Ford. He was kind of reaching over the back, but he got all ball, and then that's what pulled the arm down. And so Ford has just picked up his second foul. And couldn't really get the arm out there. So Ford didn't really make contact behind him. He was reaching over trying to tip it out. Vasquez, though, going hard for the ball. That's how you got to do it. Had 2 hands on the ball. Ford had his hand underneath, and as he pulled it down, Ford couldn't get his arm out, and that's where the elbow made contact on the shoulder. That's what led to the foul. Ford going back and forth with the official, calmly, politically. Ford right now with 2 fouls. Front end of a 1-1 now for Vasquez is good. One of the great free throw shooters, not just in the league, but in the history of Montana basketball. He's 87% this year. Lining up to second. And it is good. 8 points for Josh Vasquez. 4-point lead for the Grizzlies. 4.5 to play in the first half. Rob Ford playing with 2 personal fouls. Turner, step back 3. Rimming, no. Rebound tip. Cats can't win it. Vasquez has it, and he's on the move from right to left. Vasquez to the top. Giving to Whitney. Cats doing a nice job recovering there. Getting back in transition. Whitney on the right wing. Takes it up to the top. Guarded by Ford. Whitney crossing over. Kicks it out to Sawyer in the left corner. He works on Olmstead. Now posted up mid-post. Gets into the paint. Doubled whistle. Travel. Eddie Turner came over with a little help defense. And the Grizzlies have their 4th turnover. MSU only has 1. Little foul trouble. Garacki and Ford each with 2 personal fouls. We got a tight one in Boise. Who's going dancing? Montana leads Montana State 28-24 with 3:57 to go in the first half. Big Sky Conference Tournament Championship. Back to the First Interstate Bank broadcast position after this. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball presented by Learfield.
At Firehouse Subs, a portion of every purchase helps provide much-needed life-saving equipment to first responders across the country. That's why at Firehouse Subs, they make their subs differently, because their subs can make a difference. Their family of restaurant owners and local crews are proud to continue to serve you the hot, hearty, life-saving subs you crave every day. In fact, it's never been easier to grab their subs to go with Rapid Rescue to go. Save time when you order online at firehousesubs.com or on their app. Firehouse Subs, enjoy more subs, save more lives.
There is a local ranch just outside of Boise, Idaho, that has masterfully bred Japanese Wagyu cattle with American Angus cattle. Now this American-style Wagyu beef is available to you and your family. Rosars presents Snake River American-style Wagyu beef. Snake River Farms beef is famously found in many exclusive 5-star steak restaurants. Snake River Farms, available at your local neighborhood Rosars.
It was a nice spring day, so I decided to do a little work around the house. I didn't think anything of it. I've dug 1,000 holes 1,000 times, until I hit a shallow gas line. The repair cost me over $5,000, and in one fell swoop, the family vacation was kaput. I know I'm not the only one, but it still hurts. Next time I'm calling 811 before I dig.
Learn from Jerry and hundreds of others. Call 811 before you dig.
Brought to you by Montana811.org.
It's the Big Sky Tournament Championship, and Montana State trailing the rival 28-24. It's the Grizzlies and the Bobcats with 3:57 to go in the first half. MSU again trailing 28-24. But it is Bobcat ball as they come out of the timeout. Bridger Brewing is home to award-winning locally crafted beer and pizza. Bridger Brewing, cheers to every adventure being better than the last. Rob Ford playing with 2 personal. No, he's not. He did just check out. He's saying some last words to the guys. So Ford takes a seat along with Garacki, who have 2 fouls apiece. Jed Miller checks in, who has played probably 7 of the most impactful tournament minutes. He was key down the stretch to weather the pressured full court press by Weber State in the quarters, and he hit the clinching free throws last night. Turner, alley-oop, Olmstead, one hand jam. We've seen them with 2, this time with 1, and Montana State back to within 2. Turner and Olmstead combining on that. John Olmstead having a big night. Whitney guarded by Miller, throws out to Moody, takes it into the left corner. Guarded by Turner. Moody out to the left wing, trying to find room, nowhere to breathe. Throws out to Oki at the top. Oki pivoting on the wing, fires to Vasquez on the right wing. That looked like his third option, six to shoot. Vasquez breaking it down into the lane, pulls up four to shoot underneath to Oki. He lays it up with the left hand. No good, air ball, shot clock violation. No, they're going to keep it going. Either way, Cats get a stop, chance to tie or take the lead. Turner blocked by Vasquez. Fight for the loose ball, out of bounds, and it's staying with Montana State. Whitney trying to save it, jumped over the baseline. He threw it off Turner, but then it ricocheted off Turner and hit Whitney, who was on the baseline. Rob Ford, the extra coach on the bench, keeps popping up, shouting out instructions to his boys. 28-26, Grizzlies leading, 3 minutes to go, first half, into Lekala from the right corner. Bounce pass to Olmstead at the top. Tip over to Miller. Miller into the lane, pulls up the free throw line, kicks it out. Lekalot, right wing three, book it. Just what the doctor ordered. Only the third Wendy's three-pointer of the night for Montana State after a quiet start from beyond the arc. Bobcats back in front thanks to Sheridan Sand. 2:35 to go, first half. MSU in front in the tournament final. Whitney, a calm dribble at the top, takes it left to the elbow, pulls up his jumper. Line drive is good. That was a low line drive of a shot. Brandon Whitney looking to continue his Grizzlies career. 9 points. Miller on the drive, pulls up his floater. Rimming no, tip for the rebound, and Montana comes away with it. 30-29, Grizzlies in front. Whitney to the elbow, keeps the dribble, almost lost his balance. Final 2 minutes, 10 seconds of the first half. Whitney up at the top. Still has the dribble. Whitney against Patterson, breaking it down, pulls up the long two, rimming no, Lekalot the rebound. MSU from left to right, Turner into the front court, Cats down one. Final 2 minutes of the first half. Turner, pump fake at the free throw line, kicks it out to Lekalot. He's on the drive down to the left baseline. Picks up the dribble, gives to Olmstead, spins to his right shoulder, pump fake, up, draws the foul. Shifty, wildly veteran moves in the post by John Olmstead. The foul is on Laulu Oki, and Olmstead is going to the line. What a career it has been for Olmstead. 4 years at Arizona State, played just 39 games, had just 11 career points, 30 career rebounds. That was it. Now tonight, he's been one of the main engines in this tournament final as he misses the first free throw. 8 points on 4 of 6 from the field. However, MSU 0 of 3 from the free throw line and 3 of 14 from the three-point line, just 21% from beyond the arc. Now you figure the averages will turn around at some point. Next free throw for Olmstead is good. And Olmstead has 9 points, trying to extend his incredible storybook career. We're all tied up, 30 points apiece, 95 seconds to go in the first half. Pressure's on the senior Leighton Grizzlies. Cats playing with house money. Moody, left wing three, no, but a foul. That's on Patterson, that's his second. Didn't give Moody a chance to land. Made a contact and collided with him. No flop, right call. Second foul on Patterson, so the Cats find themselves in some foul trouble. Garacki, Ford, Patterson, two apiece. And Anon Moody going to the line. The seventh year Big Sky player at three different Big Sky schools. With the man bun all braided up, knocks down the first free throw. He played 2 years at Southern Utah, 3 years at North Dakota, and now a second year here at Montana. He had a freshman red shirt, had a medical red shirt before the pandemic, then the free year because of the COVID virus, and the year that did not count against players' eligibility. Moody hitting the free throw. He's hit two, the first two, and he's got the third due. Exhales, bends the knees, puts it up, puts it in. 33-30, Grizzlies leading. 1:29 to go in the first half. Montana State with the ball. Cats trying to survive here late with some foul trouble at the end of the first half. Eddie Turner at the top. Probes to the elbow. Gets to the mid post. Pivoting. Gets rid of it out to the right wing. Here's Jed Miller. Backs it out on the right wing. Bounce to Olmstead on the perimeter right side. Hand off to Miller. He's behind the screen. Takes it into the lane. Puts up the free throw line jumper. Off the glass. No good. Jackson Knapp with a rebound. MSU not shooting the way they've been shooting throughout the tournament. Moody up to the top. Crosses over to the wing. Throws over to the right wing, Deshaun Thomas, who had the hot hand last night in the semifinal win for the Grizzlies. Guarded by Miller. Has to kick it out to Whitney, to Vasquez. Steps to his right, tries the three after the pump, and it's good. The Grizzlies are shooting the lights out. Josh Vasquez, a big part of it. That was his third three in a timeout called by Montana State as the Grizzlies build a six-point lead. Grizzlies 36, Bobcats 30, 40 seconds to go in the first half. At First Interstate Bank, it's about supporting our communities and cheering on our teams. Thank you for letting us be your trusted community bank for more than 50 years. First Interstate Bank, built for you, member FDIC. Josh Vasquez, the star today, 11 points in the first half, 3 of 4 from downtown. He's hit 3 of the 4 three-point makes for the Grizzlies. He's one of the guys who's part of this senior-laden club, and in some ways for the Grizzlies, this is a bit of a disappointing regular season, going 12-6 with all that they brought back. One of the most experienced teams in the Big Sky. A lot of people had them pick for second in the conference behind Dylan Jones and Weber State. Well, MSU dispatched Weber State for the third consecutive year in the tournament, and they're trying to let that lead to a third consecutive tournament championship. 36-30, Grizzlies in front, 40 seconds to go in the first half. MSU with the ball on the right sideline with three starters on the bench due to foul trouble. Lekalot inbounds to Turner at the top of the key. Rob Ford did come back in, so did Patterson on that last whistle. They're two of the starters with those two fouls, so they're back on the floor. Turner at the top, crossing over, comes left around the screen, pulls up, elbow jumper, got it. Yep, Eddie Turner, first 2 points, catch back to within four. Shot clock off, 25 seconds to go in the first half. Get a stop here, you're feeling good going into the locker room. Vasquez, a calm dribble, hands it off to the senior point guard, Brandon Whitney, against his counterpart, Rob Ford. 12 seconds left in the first half. This is a massive possession of the championship. 8 seconds left. Whitney on the drive, going to the rack, righty layup, got it to go around Ford. 3 seconds left in the half. Eddie Turner ahead to Ford, his pass stolen, and that is the end of the first half. 6-point game. Grizzlies were celebrating a bucket that was made from Vasquez after the final whistle of the half, but that one, we promise, will not count. Both the maroon and the blue on their feet celebrating their teams going to the locker room. We've got a good one in the Big Sky Tournament Championship. It's Montana 38, Montana State 32. We're taking a break from the First Interstate Bank broadcast position. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball presented by Learfield.
Hello, tomorrow. We may not know exactly what you've got in store for us, for our routines and our normals. But here's the thing. Turns out, we've got this. We haven't seen everything, but we have seen ourselves be more ready for whatever you bring than we thought we would be. So when it comes to tomorrow, bring on the day. First Interstate, built for you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Visit us at firstinterstate.com.
You are a Bobcat fan, and your seat matters. Section 108, right in the middle, and a perfect view of the fast break, alley-oop, and slam dunk. At Kendall Ford of Bozeman, we're a proud supporter of Montana State Athletics. We're big fans of teamwork, dedication, and helping customers find the best deal on the perfect vehicle to fit their needs. Where you sit matters, as in the driver's seat. Get started at KendallFordBozeman.com. Kendall, let's start something great.
Universal Athletic has been a proud supporter of Bobcat Athletics for over 45 years. Check out their great selection of Bobcat apparel and accessories for all your game day needs. Shop in store at their North 7th Avenue location or online at shop.msubobcats.com for everything you need to cheer on your Bobcats. Universal Athletic, a proud supporter of Bobcat Athletics for over 45 years. Go Cats!
Here's to home. Here's to Northwest Crossing, where kids can be kids, and adults can also be kids, and new neighbors feel like old friends. Welcome to Bozeman, Montana's newest master-planned community. Life here comes with nearby, top-rated Bozeman schools, on-site eateries and retail, office space, parks, trails, and so much more, including new homes from the 500s to 800s, exclusively built by Williams Homes. Learn more at nwxbzn.com. nwxbzn.com.
Welcome back to the Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Montana halftime show. The Bobcats today at halftime of the Big Sky Tournament Championship, trailing the arch rivals. It's Montana 38, Montana State 32. It's been a good one so far. Really, all in all, Montana played significantly better than Montana State in that first half, and it's just a six-point game, so I think there's a glass half full versus glass half empty type situation here for MSU. The guards for Montana, it's that trio of Moody, Whitney, and Vasquez. When they score 35 or more points, they're pretty darn unstoppable. They had 30 combined points in the first half. Vasquez had 11. Brandon Whitney had 11. He's playing like a senior, trying to survive and extend his Division I life. Moody with 8. Oki with 8. That's it. So really only 4 players have scored. Vasquez 11, Whitney 11, Moody and Oki with 8. That's it. The Cats in some ways have done a nice job offensively, but in other ways, Montana has had their stars show up and show out to this point. For Montana State, John Olmstead the leading scorer. 9 points for MSU. 4 of 6 from the field. Bobcats have 7 points from Rob Ford, who played sometime with 2 fouls in that first half. Ford also had 4 rebounds and 3 assists. 4 points for Tyler Patterson, 3 for Lekalot, 4 for Walker, 3 for Garacki, only got 2 shots off, and 2 for Eddie Turner. Montana State shot 42% from the field, 21% from 3, just 3 of 14. Will the Bobcats get back to their sharp shooting ways from beyond the arc? That is to be determined, but they certainly need to do that sooner rather than later. MSU 1 of 4 from the free throw line. That did not help either. 6 assists for the Bobcats on 14 field goal makes. That's 6 assists sponsored by Aware Mental Health Services. Bobcats just minus 2 on the glass. That's a good sign against this very good rebounding team of Montana that was plus 2 on the glass during the conference season. And Montana State, 2 turnovers. Grizzlies with 4. So Bobcats all in all, not perfect, but not bad. Right now trailing 38-32 at halftime. Going to feel pretty decent about things for the Bobcats right now. We remind you the Town Pump is a proud sponsor of the Brawl of the Wild rivalry series between Montana State University and the University of Montana. It's all sports all season long. Look for special Brawl of the Wild promotions at your local Town Pump. The selection show is coming up on St. Patrick's Day. It is this coming Sunday. It'll start at 3 o'clock and run for an hour. So it's 3 to 4 o'clock Mountain Time coming up on Monday. That is the selection show. The Bobcats hoping to be hanging out and soaking that one in. But if they're going to do that, they're going to have to outscore the Grizzlies in the second half. Montana trailing 38-32 at the break. We also remind you that you join Champ's new Kids Club, presented by Billings Clinic Bozeman. Your $40 membership fee gets you game tickets, Bobcat gear, and more. Sign up today at msubobcats.com/Champs Kids Club. All right, we're taking a break on the Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Montana halftime show. The Bobcats trailing the Grizzlies 38-32. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
Rocky Mountain Credit Union has supported Montana State Athletics for over 40 years and provides a local credit union for past, present, and future Bobcats. You can have it all with RMCU. Low rates, local banking, a place to start saving, or work on building your credit. Visit your local branch or online at rmcu.net to become a member today. That's rmcu.net. Go Bobcats!
Bridger Brewing is home to award-winning locally crafted beer and pizza and is proud to support all things Bobcat sports. Open 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily, last beer served at 8 p.m., and located right across from the Brick Breeden Fieldhouse. Stop by after the game today to enjoy a cold pint of beer and a slice of made-from-scratch delicious pizza. Dine-in service and online ordering for takeout are both available. Check out BridgerBrewing.com and at Bridger Brewing on Instagram and Facebook, and stay tuned for updates on our newest adventure in Three Forks, Montana.
From our 1946 roots, providing lumber for Yellowstone National Park, to our current headquarters in Bozeman, we at Simpkins Hallen believe in building the Gallatin Valley's future while continuing to honor its past. Contractors large and small benefit from our decades of experience and our extensive network of suppliers. We can source the materials you need, no matter the project. For all your building needs, go to where longstanding traditions have met with quality building products for over 75 years. Simpkins Hallen, a Montana tradition among builders since 1946.
Town and Country Foods is a proud supporter of Bobcat Athletics. As a locally owned company, we believe the benefit of buying local helps support the local economies in Southwest Montana. Our stores offer great selections of items you need every day, including organics, specialty foods, fresh meats and produce, along with incredible selections from our bakery and deli departments. Town and Country Foods is 100% employee owned and serves Southwest Montana with 8 locations. Visit your local Town and Country Foods today. Go Cats!
This copyrighted broadcast is an exclusive presentation of Learfield.
38-32, Montana leading at Montana State at halftime of the Big Sky Tournament Championship. We're on the Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Montana halftime show. We also remind you, at Montana's Ribbon Chop House, our staff is dedicated to creating extraordinary experiences that raise the bar in each of our communities. Enjoy premium steaks, fresh seafood, award-winning baby back ribs. We look forward to sharing a little Rocky Mountain hospitality with you. All right, let's get to our McDonald's delivery of the half for Montana State. Robert Ford III with 3 assists in the first half. Eddie Turner with a pair of assists that led to some alley-oop dunks from John Olmstead, who was the Bobcats' leading scorer with 9 points in the first half. So that is our McDonald's delivery of the half, and of course, all assists are sponsored by Aware Mental Health Services. Take another break on the Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Montana halftime show. Cats trailing the Grizzlies 38-32 at halftime, the Big Sky Tournament final. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
For all of your tree and lawn care needs, turn to Arbor Medic Tree and Lawn Care, a proud sponsor of MSU Athletics. Arbor Medic Tree and Lawn Care provides outstanding service for your landscape for pruning, removals, stump grinding, tree moving, plant health care, and all of your landscaping maintenance needs. Check out Arbor Medic Tree and Lawn Care. Wade Dooley Certified Arborist.
Hello, tomorrow. We may not know exactly what you've got in store for us, for our routines and our normals. But here's the thing. Turns out, we've got this. We haven't seen everything, but we have seen ourselves be more ready for whatever you bring than we thought we would be. So when it comes to tomorrow, bring on the day. First Interstate, built for you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Visit us at firstinterstate.com.
It's time for a wellness tip from SCL Health, now Intermountain Health, an official health partner of the Bobcats. Do you ever feel winded after attending a Bobcats game? Here's something you might not know. Of course you do. You're a true blue and gold Bobcat fan. You sing the fight song at the top of your lungs. Stand up and cheer. Cheer long and loud for dear Montana State. That being said, keep those lungs healthy. The Bobcats need your energy. Learn more at intermountainhealth.org.
Everybody in your crew identifies as either Big Mac Burger, McNuggets, or McCrispy Sandwich. But you're the Filet-O-Fish Sandwich all day. That crispy fish, that savory tartar sauce, that melty cheese, that pillowy bun. Yeah, you get it. Every time.
Now, BOGO for a dollar has your crew covered with Big Mac, Chicken McNuggets, and Filet-O-Fish. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal. Valid for items equal or lesser value.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
We are back. Montana State is trailing Montana 38-32 at halftime of the Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Montana halftime show. Remind you, the Bobcats need your support to go for the win. Donate to the Bobcat Club's Free to Win campaign to help us reach our $3 million goal supporting student athletes. Earlier today, the Eastern Washington women punched their ticket to the big dance. They defeated Northern Arizona. So Eastern Washington cutting down the nets on the Idaho Central Arena floor earlier today. Take another break, getting ready for the second half. It's Montana State and Montana, the Big Sky Tournament Final. Back after this, you're listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
Bridger Brewing is home to award-winning locally crafted beer and pizza and is proud to support all things Bobcat sports. Open 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily, last beer served at 8 p.m., and located right across from the Brick Breeden Fieldhouse. Stop by after the game today to enjoy a cold pint of beer and a slice of made-from-scratch delicious pizza. Dine-in service and online ordering for takeout are both available. Check out BridgerBrewing.com and at Bridger Brewing on Instagram and Facebook, and stay tuned for updates on our newest adventure in Three Forks, Montana.
It's the season of home improvement, and Williams Plumbing will help you tackle the big stuff. Are old roots clogging your sewer line? Williams has the tools to fix it. Have you checked your septic system lately? We have the knowledge and experience to maintain or repair it. Looking to install a yard hydrant? We'll do it promptly and professionally. Don't sweat the big stuff. Call Williams Plumbing today.
At Montana State University, students shape signature experiences that take them across the state and into local communities. MSU is dedicated to its land-grant mission, integrating transformational learning, discovery, and service that improves lives. You'll find our students teaching across Montana, conducting research in the heart of Yellowstone National Park, or even creating small shelter prototypes to address homelessness. Montana State University. Think outside.
Bozeman Spirits Distillery. Craft distilling award-winning spirits for over 9 years, making some of your favorites like Bobcat Gold Bourbon, Montana 1889 Whiskey, Cold Spring Huckleberry Vodka, Jim Bridger Bourbon, and many more. Visit the tasting room, try signature craft cocktails, and purchase bottles today. Located at 121 West Main, Bozeman Spirits Distillery, downtown Bozeman.
In Montana, parenting is important to us. Figuring it out doesn't come easy. In the ParentingMontana.org podcast, we talk with experts about the challenges and the joys of being in a parenting role. ParentingMontana.org, tools for your child's success. We have wrapped up the Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Montana halftime show, and we are getting ready for the start of the second half with Montana State trailing Montana 38-32. All in all, 6-point deficit, not the worst thing in the world here. Montana State only shot 3 of 14 from downtown in that first half after they were so electric in the first couple of games. And for Montana, they really did shoot very well, and it was their stars that shined the brightest in that first half. Montana only had 4 players score. It was Vasquez and Whitney with 11 apiece, Moody and Oki with 8. That's it. Deshaun Thomas did not score. Trajan Sawyer did not score. MSU ended up minus 2 on the glass. Not that bad for MSU. So they're in a good place right now, for now. Remember, Montana State also ran into some foul trouble with Garacki, Ford, and Patterson all picking up 2 fouls in the first half. So could be a lot worse. Glass half full, glass half empty. Not really sure. We'll know more in about 20 minutes, because one of the treasures of the state is going dancing into the NCAA tournament for Montana State, eyeing their 6th NCAA tournament. We'll see if they can get this thing done today. All right, there we go. That was the final horn, and we are ready to rock. 5th Big Sky tournament here in Boise over the last 6 years. Montana State has played the final in 4 of those 5. Eddie Turner, Tyler Patterson, Brian Garacki, Rob Ford, and Brandon Walker on the floor. This is the last time we see Rob Ford, the blue and gold. For Montana, same starting 5. Vasquez, Whitney, Moody, plus Thomas and Oki. Travis DeCure, the 10th year head coach, who won his 200th game at Montana last night. A couple of final words for his guys. And Montana ready to inbound, going from left to right on the left sideline. Vasquez gives it to Whitney. We are underway. Potentially the final 20 minutes of the season. Hoping we get some more in the big dance. Oki up the top. Slows down the left wing, hands off Moody. Moody turns the corner, gives it to Whitney. He's double, tip free, loose on the floor, and Brandon Walker comes away with it. Bobcats force the turnover. MSU from right to left. Garacki steps to the elbow, pulls up, mid-range jumper, short, fight for the rebound, and one by Montana. Grizzlies into the front court. Moody on the drive, lefty layup swirls home. Moody in the double figures. He's got 10. He had a couple of big games during the regular season against the Cats, including 29 points in Missoula. MSU down by 8 with the ball. Crucial possession here in the first minute of the second half. Handoff for Walker at the free throw line. He's holding on the elbow, gives it to Turner. He's at the top, Turner. Into the lane, turns, righty floater, good. Nothing but the bottom of the net. Eddie Turner, just as smooth as can be. Cats and Grizzlies trading buckets to start the second half. 6-point lead for the Grizzlies. 18:50 to go first half. Oki at the top. Gives it to Whitney beyond the arc. Ooh, he wanted Oki, who was free in the post. Didn't get it to him. Whitney on the drive. Into the lane. Goes up. Blocked by Walker. Rebound tipped out. Thomas comes away with it. He's open for a topside three. Yep. First points for Deshaun Thomas, who can be lights out from beyond the arc. That was just one of those bounces that did not go the Cats' way. MSU down by 9 with the ball. 18:20 to go in the second half. Turner on the drive, going up against Whitney. Pump fake, pivots, kicks it to Walker. He steps inside, goes up, missed the layup as Oki had the defense. And this one right here, this is the possession that could make it a two-possession game. Oki makes the catch in transition. Ooh, pump fake, lays it in as Garacki goes down hard. The pump fake, and he kind of caught the leg of Garacki, who came down on his shoulder and tailbone, and he is in a lot of pain. That one hurt. And it's an 11-point game after the Oki lay-in. And you hope Garacki is not seriously hurt here. Still laying on his side. Now sitting up. Oh, that did not feel good. Head in his hands. Trainer with him. Logie helps him up to his feet. And he's all right. It's Bobcat built right there. Good sportsmanship. Grizzlies on their feet applauding as well. Yeah, he's pointing to his left hip. That one, that's going to be the bruise of the size of a Frisbee. .18:07 to go in the ballgame. Montana leading 45-34. Garacki takes a seat. He's actually going to go back into the locker room right now and get checked out. Like a lot into the game. Cats got to have a bucket here. Grizzlies starting to turn the tide. Turner to his left, to the elbow. Picks up the dribble. Slings out to Walker on the right elbow. Hand off for Ford. Bounce pass to Walker. Steps in. Lays it. Good and one. Deshaun Thomas the foul. Got him on the arm. Walker finishes anyway. He's got 6 points. And he's going to the line to try to complete a 3-point play. Real Milk is a nutrient-rich product. It contains 13 essential nutrients from vitamin A to zinc, all of which are important for a healthy immune system and overall wellness. That's 13 nutrients with seemingly endless benefits. Reach for Milk and make every sip count. Cats have struggled from the free throw line today. And they continue. 1 of 5 from the stripe. Brandon Walker missed it. If you're going to win a championship game, you got to shoot better from the free throw line. 17:45 to go in the game. Grizzlies leading 45-36. Cats really can't let Montana get any more breathing room. Oki turns the corner to the rack. Two-hand jam. Breakdown defensively. Oki with 10 points. 11-point lead for the Grizzlies. 17.5 to play in the ballgame. Walker spins the free throw line. Picks up the dribble. No, he still has it. Takes it into the mid post. Back and down. Back and in. Doubled. Goes up anyway and lays it home as he tumbles to the ground. Brandon Walker starting to heat up. He's got 8. Whitney into the front court. Fires to Moody. He's on the drive from the left wing to the rack. Finger roll up and yes. And then Moody, 12 points. MSU down by 11. 17 minutes to go in the game. Ford has the dribble on the right wing. Gives it to Walker at the top. Around to Lekalot on the left wing. Up to Ford at the top of the key. Ford on the drive. Gets to the mid post. And he kicks it out to Walker. Walker on the drive into the lane. Draws a double out to Patterson. Tries the left wing three. That is no good. Moody with the contest. Looked like he caught him on the forearm. I guess not. And Montana has the rebound. Trying to extend to their 11-point lead. Grizzlies slow it down momentarily. Whitney to his left, gets the mismatch against Walker, brings it out to the top. Against Walker, still breaking it down to the mid post, picks up the dribble, has to get rid of it out to Moody. 10 to shoot. Moody against Patterson, crosses over, pump fake, leans in, contested three, no good, and MSU has the rebound. Good defense. Now you got to score. That snaps the stretch of four straight makes by the Grizzlies. Turner on the drive, spins into the lane, turns, floater up, yep. Eddie Turner rolling now, he's got six. MSU down by nine, 16 minutes to go in the game. Who is moving on to the NCAA tournament? Moody on the left wing, trying to drive on Turner, lost it, out of bounds, Cats, no, he falls out of bounds, Cats steal it back, forward into the front court, transition three, front iron, no. Walker the rebound, his putback is good. Bobcats on the comeback trail, powered by Brandon Walker. His 10th point tonight. Cats back to within seven. 15:30 to go in the game. Travis DeCure slowing it down, telling his guys to cool it down a bit. Whitney up to the top, Oki back to Whitney, playing catch on the perimeter. Oki hands it off, Vasquez stolen. Eddie Turner in transition against Vasquez, going to the cup, pump fake up, lays it, no! And then a foul late by Whitney, and it'll be a shooting foul for Eddie Turner. Montana State taking some defense, trading it in for some offense, and Eddie Turner will be at the free throw line when we come back. This thing felt like it was in dire straits for a moment, and the Cats now on a quick run. We're taking a break from First Interstate Bank broadcast position. The Big Sky Tournament Championship. 15 minutes, 12 seconds to go in the ball game. Montana leading Montana State 49-42. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball presented by Learfield.
At Jersey Mike's, watching them freshly slice the meat and cheese for my sub is a sight to behold. The layers of ham, salami, and pepperoni are even more glorious than the pink and orange layers of a sunrise. Yeah, the sun's pretty and all that, but in about 7 billion years, it's going to explode, obliterating the Earth and every living thing on it. And if there's no sun, there's no subs. Meanwhile, the only thing a sub ever obliterated was my hunger. Freshly sliced right in front of you. It's a Jersey Mike's thing, a sub above.
At Montana State University, students shape signature experiences that take them across the state and into local communities. MSU is dedicated to its land-grant mission, integrating transformational learning, discovery, and service that improves lives. You'll find our students teaching across Montana, conducting research in the heart of Yellowstone National Park, or even creating small shelter prototypes to address homelessness. Montana State University. Think outside.
When a power line has fallen down, it can be downright dangerous and even deadly. That's because downed lines can still energize the ground and objects around them. To help keep you and others safe, Northwestern Energy says stay at least 35 feet or the length of a semi-truck away from a downed power line and anything the line is touching. You should always assume the line is live, and if you see a downed line, immediately call 911 and warn others. Northwestern Energy, delivering a bright future.
Bobcat Basketball is brought to you in part by Kendall Ford Lincoln of Bozeman, a proud sponsor of Montana State Athletics. From your seat at the game to your driver's seat, enjoy every minute. When you're ready for something new, get started at KendallFordBozeman.com. Kendall, let's start something great. We're at the First Interstate Bank broadcast position. It's the Big Sky Tournament Final. Montana State looking for their third consecutive dance. And the arch rivals, Montana, they lead it 49-42 over Montana State with 15 minutes, 12 seconds to go in the ballgame. However, Eddie Turner's starting to heat up now. So is Brandon Walker. And Eddie Turner is going to the line for a couple of free throws. Walker with 10 points to lead the Cats. Olmstead has nine, all in the first half. Ford has seven. He hasn't quite gotten going yet. Ford with 7 points, four rebounds, four assists, sponsored by Aware Mental Health Services. MSU just 3 of 16 from the three-point line so far tonight. Gonna need that to get going. Walker taking a seat now. Olmstead and Lekalot on in the front court, along with Patterson, Ford, and Turner in the backcourt. On the other side, it's Moody, Whitney, Vasquez in the backcourt, Knapp at the four, and Deshaun Thomas at the five. So a very athletic five on the floor for Montana. Turner with two free throws due. no good on the first. Montana State is 1 of 6 from the free throw line. You just hope that that is not what we look back at as the difference. The next is good. Ryan Garacki went down with an injury earlier. He is back out on the bench. Haven't seen him back on the floor yet, but he is not getting any more attention. 15 minutes to go in the game. Montana State only down by 6. Montana with the ball. Deshaun Thomas guarded by Turner. Picks up the dribble and throws it out to the left wing for Whitney. Whitney probes into the lane. Throws out to Vasquez. He's got the three. No. Olmstead the rebound. Cats got away with one. Ford out to Lekala to the left wing. Goes to Turner. Turner to his right. Turns the corner. Pulls up his free throw line jumper. That's too strong. Rebound is won by Montana. Grizzlies from left to right. Moody into the front court. Goes up to Whitney. Grizzlies slow it down for a moment with a 6-point lead. 14:28 to go in the ballgame. Whitney guarded by Ford way out high. Whitney to the top. Picked up by Olmstead now. Steps back for a long two. No. And the rebound tipped and won by the Grizzlies. Then knocked out of bounds, staying with Montana. That should have been a rebound for Montana State, but just kind of took a funny bounce. And that one hurts. ...49-43, Montana in front, 14 minutes to go in the ball game. Whitney on the left wing. 10 to shoot. Whitney still with a bounce. 6, handoff for Moody, tries a contested 3, left it short. Offensive rebound by Deshaun Thomas underneath. And then he tries to pass it, and it is knocked free and out of bounds. The shot clock reset to 28, should have reset to 20, so it should be 18 seconds on the shot clock. The officials catch it as well. So it should be 18 on the shot clock. Yep, that's what they're going to put on. So Montana will inbound from underneath their own basket. Vasquez looking. Still looking. Gets it to Thomas. Oh, and they called the foul on Lekalot of the contest. So Lekalot with his second foul, and Deshaun Thomas is going to the line. Thomas was quiet, only 2 points in the quarterfinals, going 0 of 6 from the field. Then he had the hot hand to start the night last night in the semifinals against Idaho State with 21. First free throw is good. Thomas was scoreless in the first half. After that free throw, he has 4. One more to come. This game has been fairly tight. Grizzlies had an 11-point lead momentarily. Thomas misses the second free throw. Right now, a 7-point advantage for the Grizzlies. Bobcats with the ball. 13:45 left tonight, potentially, for the season. Turner breaking it down, gets it underneath, kicks it out to Patterson, makes a contested catch. Back to Turner on the left wing. Turner dribbles right, takes it into the lane, gets down to the right block, lays it up and in off the glass. Eddie Turner's just getting whatever he wants now. He's got 9 points in the final. MSU down by 5, 13:25 to go in the game. Hasn't been much where either team has taken big control. Coach Logie turns and pumps up the cat crowd. Whitney on the drive, throws out to Knapp. He takes it to the free throw line. Had his pocket picked by Turner. MSU coming the other way. Ford to the top, into the lane. Pulls up his floater, rimming. No, got his own rebound. Ford to the right corner. He's open. His three ball. Yes! Rob Ford from downtown. MSU trailing by 2. Grizzlies up 50-48, 12:50 to go in the ballgame. Coach Logie pointing to his watch, saying, now's the time. This is the place. Whitney into the lane, throws out to Thomas. A contested 3. That's no good. MSU the rebound. They got a chance to tie or take the lead. Out to Lekalot on the right wing. Giving to Olmstead at the top. Handoff for Patterson. Crosses over. Gets free. His right wing 3. Oh, yeah. Tyler Patterson from downtown. Bobcats back on top. Cats ain't done yet. Whitney at the top with a dribble. Handoff for Knapp. Back to Whitney. 10 to shoot. He backs it out on the perimeter. Looking for the post. Inside to Thomas. One-on-one against Lekalot. Gets himself into the paint, tries a fall-away contested jumper, no good, but Olmstead gets tagged for the bailout foul with 1 second on the shot clock. I don't know about that. really looked like Thomas was going to be going down regardless. That is a big call, and Olmstead has his second foul. We'll take a break, but the Bobcats are back on top as the three ball is starting to fall again. In the Big Sky Tournament Championship, 11 minutes, 51 seconds to go in the game. Montana State leads Montana 51-50. Back to the First Interstate Bank broadcast position after this. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
When your day one proves they're a real one by showing up with McDonald's breakfast before you even get out of bed. The friends don't let friends skip breakfast deal.
Real friends also understand if you eat their hash browns before you even drive back. It's buy one, get one for $1 at McDonald's with 5 options to mix and match. Sausage McMuffin, burrito, McGriddles, biscuit, or hash browns. Prices and participation may vary. Cannot be combined with any other offer or combo meal. Valid for item of equal or lesser value.
No matter how far you may go, there's always one just down the road.
Join the Town Pump Fountain and Coffee Club with Pump It Up Rewards. Buy 5 of any size fountain drink or coffee and get your 6th free. It pays to be a Pump It Up Rewards member. Town Pump, convenient and right down the road.
As a Montana parent, I want to be at my best for my child. I've learned that if I want to be at my best, then I need to take care of myself. ParentingMontana.org has podcast episodes about taking care of my own health and well-being, improving my relationship with my parenting partner, and supporting my child's physical and mental health. I found the podcast to be informative, relatable, and I can tune in whenever I have time. ParentingMontana.org, tools for your child's success.
Brought to you by SAMHSA and Montana DPHHS.
Champ and Monty both pulling the Sacramento State Hornet off the floor. Shirt all ripped up. They're putting on a show. So are the Cats and the Grizzlies. 11:51 to go in the ballgame. MSU leading 51-50 over Montana in the Big Sky Tournament Final. Let's pause 10 seconds for our network station identification. You're listening to Montana State Basketball.
1450 KMMS, Bozeman. 1340 KPRK Livingston, where Montana talks.
I'm Keaton Gillogly. Trevor Nominuk is back in the studios as our producer today. Montana State coming back from an 11-point deficit to take a one-point advantage. 11:51 to go. Montana trying to get back atop the Big Sky. They have the most titles in tournament history with 11. Montana State looking for their 5th. They're looking to go to 11-1 in Boise since 2021. Deshaun Thomas is at the line, and he misses the first free throw. So far, Montana State has dominated the 2020s in the Big Sky Tournament. Can they keep it going tonight against the team that's got the most titles in the Big Sky? Thomas splits the pair, hits his second. He's got 5 points. We got a tie game, 51 points apiece. MSU from right to left. Eddie Turner's been massive down the stretch. Turner into the lane, throws it out to Lekalot. Then to Ford. He drives into the lane, handoff. Olmstead pump fake, up draws the foul. Beautifully done. What a find by Rob Ford with a little shrug. And Olmstead going to the stripe. May have taken 4 years for John Olmstead to start writing a magical story, but it hasn't come a moment too late. Two big games at the end of the regular season against Eastern Washington and Weber State. Pivotal role here in the Big Sky Tournament. And he knocks down the first free throw. 10 points for John Olmstead, who had just 11 points total in his career at Arizona State as a walk-on. Next free throw is through. Montana State back in front, 53-51, 11:38 to go in the ballgame. Montana from left to right. Whitney out on the left wing. Up to Oki at the top. Moving around the perimeter into the post. Vasquez makes the catch and lays it in. Zach Payne saw that one before the Bobcat defense did. Easy lay-in for Vasquez. This game tied at 53. Ford into the traffic. Pivoting. Gets rid of it to the right corner. Lekalot for three. No. Rebound tipped. Olmstead won it. Back out to the top. MSU another chance. Turner to Olmstead. Back to Turner on the left wing. 11 minutes to go in a tie game in the Big Sky Final. to Olmstead. Down in the lane. Back it in on Oki. Picked up the dribble. Pivoting. Righty hook. That's good. John Olmstead right in the late script. Cats back up by two. 10:51 to go in the ball game. Who is dancing? Oki out of the left wing. Hands off for Moody. Trying to get free against Patterson. Pulls inside. His pass tip recovered by Vasquez on the right wing. Vasquez up at the top. Resets. Hand off for Whitney. Whitney against Ford. Into the lane. Had it knocked free. It's loose on the deck. Eddie Turner comes away with it. Rob Ford, the defensive player of the year, forcing the turnover, and MSU looks to extend their lead. Turner, reverse layup is good. Off the window. Eddie Turner, the third. Smooth as silk. 11 points for Eddie. Cats up by four. 10:25 to go. Now is the time. This is the place to write your legendary story. And now Moody and Patterson were getting tied up. One of those number 11s are going to be tagged for it, and I think it is Patterson. And right now, Lekalot pulling Patterson away because he's getting a little amped up. Yep, Patterson gets hit for the foul. They are going to go back and look at this here. So that's the third foul on Patterson. So they're taking a look at things now. 10:06 to go in the game. Montana State up 57-53. Moody wants to get under your skin. That's what he does. That's one of his elite skills. And he started to get under the skin of Tyler Patterson there. Patterson just needed to kind of back up a little bit. It was a light push from Moody. I mean, really light. But if you're Patterson, you just need to back up. We'll see if we got another replay here. Little contact there. Yeah, it was pretty 50-50, honestly. I thought it was a little more Patterson live, but Moody kind of grabbed his arm and pulled him to him a little bit and then had the late push. I don't know. I'm going to be really fascinated to see what the officials do. It was so kind of borderline. You did have to call something there because Moody went, or Patterson went down, and I don't know, it was really back and forth. I mean, Moody kind of hooked. Oh, yeah, Moody did give the shove there. It looked, you had a better angle where you could see it was not a blatant shove. And this is why Moody plays such a great villain. It was kind of his forearm while he swung his arm through. Not vicious. They're reviewing a flagrant. So did they call a flagrant initially on Patterson? I'm fascinated how they're going to call this because they were both kind of jockeying there. Nothing was aggressively dirty, but this is the kind of call that you have to make. And that's going to set the tone for how this game goes on. And can you keep control of one of the great rivalries in college basketball in a Big Sky tournament final? I do not envy the officials here. The Bobcats need your support to go for the win. Donate to the Bobcat Club's Free to Win campaign to help us reach our $3 million goal supporting student athletes. So for now, Patterson has been called for a foul. Listed as a personal foul, his third. Moody didn't get anything, but it did seem like Moody was just as in on it as Patterson was. So what do we got? Okay, so I think a fan's about to get ejected.
Hey, we need to go get this game going here.
Okay, I think a fan is about to get ejected. Yeah, I'm like 90% sure that's what's about to happen. We're going to get a word from the PA as well. Still waiting here to get the official word. And again, somebody is getting ejected in the Montana State crowd. Let's go, Bobcat chance begins. Yep, this is Cat Grizz. Yeah, let's see here. Okay, so they are giving something to Moody. Dead ball technical foul on Moody. Patterson also gets a foul as well, so Patterson's going to line. I think that's the right application of all of that. Moody getting an explanation right now, but look, this is what Moody does. He finds a way to get under your skin, and there was a light push. Free throw is good. Patterson hits them both. But again, I think it was the right administration of that. And this is how you keep control. The tempers are high. This is how you keep control. You don't let somebody kind of have that little push like that that Mooney had. And it wasn't aggressively or egregiously bad, but those are the things you have to call as an official to keep things from getting out of hand. So MSU up 59-53. Handoff up top. Turner into the lane. Stop. Pulls up. Floater left short. Vasquez got a piece of it. Good defense. And Montana has the rebound. 59-53. Montana State leading with 9:45 to go in the game. And yes, a Bobcat fan is getting ejected right now and escorted out by police. Yeah, this is Cat Chris. It's a brawl. Vasquez out of the left wing. Has the bounce picked up by Olmstead defensively. Up at the top, Vasquez still with a dribble. Five to shoot. Vasquez crossing over four. Vasquez to the free throw line. Tried the jumper. No good. Tip back, no. Second rebound, won by MSU. Cats got to stop. They're up 59-53. 9:19 to go in the game. Ford draws the foul on Moody. And now Moody's starting to get frustrated. Turnabout is fair play. And now that's also a big call on Moody because it's his third foul. 9:15 to go in the Big Sky Tournament Championship. MSU up by six with the ball. Patterson on the right sideline to inbound. Patterson gives it to Olmstead at the top of the key. Hand off for Lekalot. Lekalot dials up a three. Short. Rebound Montana. MSU just hasn't had it from deep. They're 5 of 20 from downtown tonight. 9 minutes remaining in the game. Whitney trying to find space. Throws to Oki at the top. He's got a standing dribble. Oki still with it. Guarded by Olmstead on the perimeter. Trying to get it to Vasquez. Turner's all over. Great defense. Bounce pass up top. Whitney has it. Whitney to his right. He's got the dribble on the right elbow. Into the right corner. Vasquez tries a three. Rimming, no. Tip back, no. Second try, no. And Olmstead has the rebound. Crowd had grown. They wanted an illegal screen, but I think it had been clean. MSU into the front court, up by six. Turner into the lane. Gets underneath. Kicks to Patterson. Right corner, three. Bang! Tyler Patterson from downtown. This is the stuff that legends are made of. 9-point lead for Montana State. We've got a timeout. Tyler Patterson knows nothing but NCAA tournaments, and he's got another shot to get the Cats to it. Let's step aside. 8:25 to go in the ballgame. Montana State, their largest lead in the Big Sky Final. MSU 62, Montana 53. Again, 8:25 to go in the contest. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
The snow is falling and temps are dropping, Bobcat fans, so it's the perfect time to cozy up with heartwarming soups and comfort food. Elevate your kitchen game and create magic tonight with La Cuisine's premium cookware. Don't forget the secret ingredient, a new top-selling cookbook. Attend a cooking class and you'll learn how to make every meal a slam dunk. La Cuisine is Bozeman's boutique kitchen store, and we can help you create the perfect table with our curated Montana-made and European dining treasures. Discover the ideal blend of style and functionality at La Cuisine, 2405 West Main.
Bozeman Spirits Distillery. Craft distilling award-winning spirits for over 9 years, making some of your favorites like Bobcat Gold Bourbon, Montana 1889 Whiskey, Cold Spring Huckleberry Vodka, Jim Bridger Bourbon, and many more. Visit the tasting room, try signature craft cocktails, and purchase bottles today. Located at 121 West Main, Bozeman Spirits Distillery, downtown Bozeman. When garage door issues happen, don't just call anybody. Call the pros at Door Tech. Our family-owned and operated business happily serves the Gallatin Valley. We install and service residential, commercial, and custom overhead doors and operators. With factory-trained and certified technicians, we're committed to quality, value, and long-term relationships. Call us at 582-1623 and let us help you with the solution to all your garage door needs. Door Tech is raising the door on quality. Your region's only premier authorized Rainer dealer.
Tyler Patterson, who has played more Big Sky Tournament games than anybody in Bobcat history. He's also tied for the most games played by a Bobcat ever. He tied Harold Frey today with his 127th game coming in this one. MSU right now on a 19-3 run. They've taken a 62-53 lead over the Grizzlies with 8:25 to go in the Big Sky Tournament final. Tyler Patterson, no stranger to putting up big performances in tournament finals in 2022. He had 14 points in the championship win against Northern Colorado thanks to 4 3-point field goals. He just hit his second of the night tonight. All three sponsored by Wendy's. Olmstead 13, Patterson 12, Turner 11, Ford with 10, Walker with 10. The Bobcat defense locking down. They've held Montana just 1 of 10 from the field on their last 10 attempts. This game is brought to you in part by the Montana State Fund, covering Montana's workers with workers' comp and safety know-how. Workplace safety, you're naked without it. More at safemt.com. The Cats battled back from an 11-point deficit early in the second half. They've got their largest lead of the day up by 9. Montana will go the length of the floor. Cats putting a little pressure in the backcourt. Vasquez inbounds it. Jordan Williams accepts the inbounds pass. He's been a light role player off the bench for them. Ahead to Tajon Sawyer. He's out on the left wing. And gets it to the point guard, Whitney. Defense chance begin for the Bobcats. Whitney, handoff for Vasquez, turns the corner into the mid post, backs it out, takes it out to the left wing. Good switching by the Bobcats on that ball screen. Thomas makes the catch off the pass, tries an elbow jumper, no good. Rebound tipped to the Bobcats, have it. Ooh, they almost let one slip through their fingers. You just can't give away any rebounds in a game like this. MSU right now down by 4 on the glass. Forward on the left wing, goes out to Olmstead at the top, gives it to Turner. He's at the point, Turner. Dribbling right, pulls up, fires into the post. Olmstead makes a contested catch, goes up, draws the foul. Missed the layup as he was blocked from behind. But Olmstead will go to the line as he draws the foul. This one coming on Jordan Williams, his first. And that'll take us to another timeout. Are the Bobcats starting to take control of this brawl? We're going to find out here down the stretch. We're taking a break from the First Interstate Bank broadcast position. This is the Big Sky Tournament Final, and Montana State is leading Montana 62-53 with 7:37 to go in the ballgame. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
For all you've been through lately, Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Montana wants to make sure you are covered in care. From preventive cancer screenings to proper control of diabetes, high blood pressure and behavioral health management, to prenatal care and child immunizations, Blue Cross and Blue Shield is by your side, reminding you preventive care is imperative care. Stay on top of your health at bcbsmt.com. Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Montana, through it all.
Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Montana, a division of Healthcare Service Corporation, a mutual legal reserve company.
For every adventure and every mishap, Bozeman Health provides expert, personalized care to each person. Going well beyond traditional health care, we're your partner in health and well-being, working together for your day-to-day and the decades to come. With care sites in Belgrade, Big Sky, and Bozeman, and with the only hospitals in the Gallatin Valley, Bozeman Health keeps your care close to home. Find a Bozeman Health provider today at bozemanhealth.org. The Rib and Chop House was founded in 2001. Our ability to grow has come through our commitment to Rocky Mountain hospitality, a concept which incorporates a casual attitude with our high-level commitment to loyalty, safety, service, and quality food. At the Rib and Chop House, our staff is dedicated to creating extraordinary experiences that raise the bar in each of our communities. Enjoy premium steaks, fresh seafood, and award-winning baby back ribs. We look forward to sharing a little Rocky Mountain hospitality with you.
Montana's Rib and Chop House has been serving Montana communities for over 20 years. Our ability to grow has come through our commitment to Rocky Mountain hospitality, a concept which incorporates a casual attitude with our commitment to loyalty, safety, service, and quality food. We hope you'll be our guest at one of our Montana locations soon. Montana State on a 19-3 run right now. Are they going to get this thing done? Coach Logie looking for his first win against one of his great mentors in the game, Travis DeCure, two guys who have been friends basically their entire lives, but they are rivals tonight as part of one of the great rivalries in college basketball, the 308th meeting between Montana State and Montana, and just the second of those 308 that will determine a Big Sky Tournament championship. Brian Garacki is on the bench. I don't believe he's come back in since he took that hard fall earlier in this second half. And John Olmstead is going to the line for Montana State. Olmstead has had a storybook finish to this season. The first free throw is no good. MSU 6 of 12 from the free throw line. Too late in the year to be missing free throws. He'll line up another. Olmstead's going to be one of those stories that will be told for years in the program. Free throw is good. As somebody who stayed ready, and when his opportunity came, he did not miss. 14 points for Olmstead in the Big Sky Tournament Championship. Bobcats have their first double-digit lead of the night with 7.5 to go against the arch rival. Whitney looking for Moody. Turner denies. Now they finally do get it to Moody. Moody on the drive against Turner. Pulls up with a runner. Way too strong off the glass. What a rebound by John Olmstead. Give me the rock. MSU the ball. Four to his right. Takes it to the free throw line. Gets into the lane. His runner is up. Rimming. Yep. Rob Ford finishes. He's got a dozen. Montana State pushing this thing out. Grizzlies from left to right. 7 minutes remaining in the ball game. This is Rob Ford's team, and he has led the Bobcats to the precipice of a third straight NCAA tournament. Whitney up at the top. Fires into the left corner. Moody on the drive. Kicks it out to the right corner. Vasquez tries a three. No! Rebound. Offensive board. Thomas had it stripped, and a foul is called underneath. And that one going on, John Olmstead, his third. Cats are near some foul trouble. Patterson and Olmstead with three. Forward Lekalak Garacki with two. 6:43 remaining. Who gets to continue? Neither team going to have a particularly good seed. Whoever gets to the NCAA tournament. And a prime lending timeout called by Montana. We're going to keep it right here. You know, last year there was a lot of question, what would the Bobcats be if they can get to the NCAA tournament? They ended up as a 14 seed, and they lost 77-65 against Kansas State. Kansas State would make that tremendous run deep into the NCAAs. MSU, though, this year, their net ranking, which is kind of that national ranking that they use for the seeding, used to be called RPI. MSU 223 in the nation, Montana 133. So Montana's seed would be much better than MSU's. But that doesn't really matter. In fact, there's probably a good chance if the Cats win this, they'll be a 16 seed. We could even see them in the first four. All of that, though, would be sorted out on Sunday on the selection show, and we would love to be looking at that and seeing where the Cats are going to go. But we're not here to count our chickens before the eggs hatch. 6:43 to go in this ballgame. There are a lot of twists and turns left. MSU leading 65-53 against the Grizzlies in the final. Grizzlies ready to inbound. Vasquez looking for the baseline. Pass is tip free and stolen. Rob Ford with it into the front court. Drop pass to Patterson, and the Cats get into their offense. Take your time. No need to rush. Let's get organized. These are the spots the Cats struggled earlier in the year. Ford on the drive. Gets underneath. Fall away jumper. Yes. Robert Ford the third. He doesn't want it to end. Cats on a massive run. Is this the run that sends them to an NCAA tournament? Of 67-53, 6.25 to go in the game. Whitney to his left, into the lane, turning, pivoting, kicks it out. Vasquez makes the catch, on the drive, gets underneath, pulls up with a jumper, that short. Olmstead the rebound. John Olmstead, 14 points, 5 boards today, trying to extend his career. It's not about how you start, it's how you finish. What a finish for Olmstead in his career. Into the post, Olmstead makes a contested catch to Turner. His three, no. Long rebound, Moody has it. He's moving in transition. Moody takes it out to the right wing, gets inside, lays it up. Block, whistle. I think we've got a goaltend. Yes, goaltend on Olmstead. They are going to take a look at it potentially on the next timeout. So they do call the goaltend. They are more inclined to call the goaltend than not, because when you call it, you get to review. When you don't call it, you can't. Rob Ford in the mess, went down hard. He's in pain. He's okay, gritting his teeth. That's Robert Ford the third. He is Bobcat built. Oh, and it's that rib. It's that right rib cage that he's holding. That's the one that got elbowed in Missoula in mid-February. Oh, and Robert Ford the third is breathing heavy. Oh, he is in pain. Doesn't matter. He's going to grit his teeth, go to work. Like the blue-collar player he is. Eddie Turner on the left wing with the Bobcats up by 12 late in the second half. Turner to the cup, lays it in. A quick flash. Eddie Turner the third to the rack. He's got 13. Moody the other way. Bounce to Whitney on the right wing. Crosses over into the lane. Whistle and a foul. Rob Ford trying to take the charge. Wasn't quite squared up. The foul will be the third on Rob. Rob Ford's going to need an ice bath after this one. He's back up on his feet now. I don't know that I've seen anybody want it more than that man right there. Robert Ford, the Portland native. 2 years at JUCO, 2 years at Idaho State, his second year at Montana State. And one of the great legendary senior years in Bobcat history. And the inbounds pass is stolen by MSU. Cats in control. Will they hang on? Up 69-55. 5 minutes, 10 seconds to go in regulation. Patterson out of the left wing. Gives it to Eddie Turner beyond the arc. Turner moves right, crosses over, working on Whitney. Gets himself into the lane, kicks it out to the top. Around to the right wing for Ford. He's on the drive. Ford into the lane, kicks it out. Turner fires the left corner three. No! Rebound tipped, loose, body's diving on the floor. It is saved, still loose. Lekalot has it, and he calls the timeout! That's how you do it! That's hustle! That's true blue and gold Bobcat basketball! Wow. Rob Ford, though, he is banged up. He is in so much pain right now, walking back to the bench. Jordan, the athletic trainer, grabs him. Ford needs to come out of this game and take a breath. Or you just keep playing through it. What hustle. So timeout by MSU. And they're going to call it the 30-second timeout. Ford has to get helped up off the bench because he was sitting for a moment. We remind you to see every pulse-pounding, buzzer-beating play in astounding detail with a patient experience and second-to-none experienced doctors and advanced technology. Vance Thompson Vision, the official LASIK cataract surgeon of the Bobcats, is your home for laser vision correction. Learn more at VanceThompsonVision.com. 4:45 to go in the game. Montana State leading 69-55. They have outscored Montana by 20 in the second half. They have held Montana just 17 points in the second half. The Grizzlies are shooting 33%. Meanwhile, MSU, this offense, which was a bit late blooming, shooting 54%, blistering performance in the second half. And it's been incredibly balanced. Ford with 14, Olmstead with 14, Turner with 13, Patterson with a dozen, Brandon Walker with 10. Brian Garacki banged up. We haven't seen him for most of the second half. Rob Ford, he should be in a body cast, and yet somehow he is out on the floor right now. When we talk about what it means to be a Bobcat, we can just put a picture of Robert Ford III. Bobcats to inbound. Lekalot finds Rob Ford. 4:45 to go in the final. Cats up 69-55. Clock is your friend. Treat them nicely. Turner fires into the post, and Olmstead makes a catch, but he draws the foul. Deshaun Thomas basically just grabbed his arm to keep a free alley-oop slam. So Thomas with the second foul. Montana State getting whatever they want above the rim with John Olmstead performing brilliantly today. Man, oh man. What a comeback by the Cats. They were down by 11 at the start of the second half. They really didn't play very well in the first half. The shot was not falling, but they let the 40 minutes play out. And the front end of the 1-1 is good for John Olmstead. No, the Cats have not shot the free throw ball very well tonight, but this is a great time to start doing it. And Olmstead hits the front end of a 1-1. Olmstead's got a massive cut underneath his jaw on the left side right now. Next free throw is good. Olmstead hits them both. I'm surprised they didn't stop play. It looks like he's about to start gushing blood on the left side of his neck. They call it a brawl for a reason. Whitney tosses into the post. Thomas against Lekalot. Thomas on the left block. Into the lane. Goes up with the right hand. Good and one. Oh, that's tough. Lekalot was kind of backing up there. Thomas able to finish. He's got seven. Lekalot with his third foul. Get Olmstead cleaned up. So free throws coming for Deshaun Thomas. We knew Montana State would have to take care of business offensively today. They have done that. 71 points. They have absolutely swarmed Montana in the second half defensively. Vasquez only has 2 points in the second half. Whitney hasn't scored. Front end, or the third free throw is good, and now they finally have caught the profuse bleeding that Olmstead has on his neck on the left side. So Thomas completes the free throw, and they're going to try to get this thing patched up. So it's kind of like just underneath the corner of his jaw on the left side. You thought this was a brawl. There's your proof. Jordan patching him up. This is the most pressure a trainer has. You get the 60 seconds to try to patch him up. And it's like he has a straight razor and he just sliced underneath his jawline. So Jordan taking care of him here. Hopefully he can stay in. He's been one of the great performers in this ball game and in this tournament. All right, looks like he's good to go. Nicely done, Jordan. 71-58, Montana State leading, 4:23 to go in the ball game. Is this golden era of Bobcat basketball going to continue? Yeah, sure, Danny Sprinkle left. Mountain West Coach of the Year leading Utah State to an outright Mountain West title with great Osabor and Darius Brown. Sure, Raekwon Battle went to West Virginia. Still plenty here in Bozeman. The Bobcats proving they're not just a football school. Rob Ford out near the half-court line. Cats eating the clock with a 13-point lead. 4:12 remaining. Ford to the elbow. Stops. Pops. Jumper. Yeah. Oh, baby. That's Robert Ford, the third right there, doing it again. He's got 17. In the final, he's got a steal. He's down underneath, and the Cats are going to try to burn some clock with 4 minutes to go. Robert Ford with another theft. One of the great defensive seasons in program history. And he's coming up with another big one now. His fourth steal of the day. His 99th of the year. Ford has the dribble with 12 to shoot. Ford to the free throw line. Stop, leans in, scoops it up. Got it to go. It's just that kind of night. Montana State in complete control of 75-58 with 3:30 remaining in the final. Moody on the drive, gets underneath, kicks it out to the right wing for Okie. Okie's got it, pivoting on the baseline. Has the dribble, now backing in on John Olmstead. Throws up to the top. Back down to Okie, makes a contested catch. He's in deep, banging bodies, lost it, picks it back up, lost it. Oh, he came down and whacked Olmstead. No call, Olmstead is hurt, and now finally a whistle. Olmstead just got smashed in the face. It was unintentional, but it did not feel good. Okie was just trying to reach down and grab it, and he just smoked him, and Olmstead is writhing in pain. Oh, what a bruising, grueling game. This, at some point, it's hard to watch. Ford is limping off the floor. Olmstead is on his back and in massive amounts of pain now. Oh! Oh, yeah, I don't know. He is writhing around. This one might be a little serious. Oki's a big man, and he came down with a huge whack. They're going to take a look at it. They didn't call anything on the floor initially. We are due a break here. He's getting helped up to his feet now. He's holding his right wrist. Jordan kind of walking him off here. Oh. I hope that's not how his story ends. They're taking a look at things. He's got a cut on his neck. He's holding his right wrist, and he just got incidentally punched in the face. It was not a true punch, but he got hit in the face. And he's walking back. That wrist does not look good. That may be the end of the story for John Olmstead, but we don't want to jump to conclusions. Hopefully he's going to be all right. We're going to take a break. 3:12 to go in the ballgame. Montana State leading 75-58 over Montana. Trying to keep this golden age going in the Big Sky Tournament Final. We're taking a break. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball presented by Learfield.
I wanted to put up a fence to protect my tomato plants. So I grabbed this and this. And then I did this. But instead of yielding a big crop, I hit a utility line and had to pay $1,200 in repairs. I didn't just lose my pride and joy. I could no longer afford the new stovetop I'd been saving up for. Next time, I'm going to make my free call to 811 before I dig.
Learn from Curry and hundreds of others. Call 811 before you dig.
Brought to you by Montana811.org.
Ready to build your brand? Think Inc. outside the box for your complete branding solutions. Located in Bozeman, Montana, we offer a full print shop for banners, signs, wraps, trade show booths and graphics, promotional products, and much more. If you can think it, we can ink it. We are a proud supporter and corporate sponsor of the MSU Bobcats. Like us on Facebook to see some of our cat wraps. Ready to build your brand? Think Inc. and call us at 406-922-6462 or visit us on the web at InkOutside.com.
There is a local ranch just outside of Boise, Idaho, that has masterfully bred Japanese Wagyu cattle with American Angus cattle. Now this American-style Wagyu beef is available to you and your family. Rosars presents Snake River American Style Wagyu Beef. Snake River Farms beef is famously found in many exclusive five-star steak restaurants. Snake River Farms, available at your local neighborhood Rosars.
Just how golden is this age of Bobcat basketball? 3 minutes, 12 seconds left in the Big Sky Tournament Final. Montana State leads 75-58 over the arch rival Grizzlies. Only the second time these two teams have met for a tournament championship. Bobcats won it in 1986. It was their first tournament title. They wouldn't win another one until 1996, thanks to Montana's own, the Helena native Danny Sprinkle. After that, Bobcats were lost in the wilderness, wandering for years and decades. They had just three tournament wins in 19 years, 2001 to 2019. Now they've won eight straight in the tournament, looking for their ninth straight. Now Coach Logie getting an explanation as John Olmstead went down, got hit pretty hard. He is walked off holding his right wrist in an absolute massive amount of pain. Don't know what the prognosis is for him. Brian Garacki, he's already out. He hasn't been out in the second half after going down hard, going up to block a shot. Rob Ford, I don't know how his limbs are still even connected to his body. Looks like he's got a limp every time he's not sprinting down the floor, stealing loose basketballs. MSU leading 75-58. 3 minutes, 12 seconds to go, standing between Montana State and a date with the dance. Eddie Turner in the backcourt, showing off the handles. What a revelation Eddie Turner has been down the stretch. Sam Lekalot out on the right wing. Throws it up to Robert Ford, the third at the top. Ford to his right, takes it over to the wing. Now down into the mid post, brings it back out, seven to shoot, handoff from Patterson, back to Ford, six to shoot, over to Walker, four, Walker against Sawyer, three, Walker gets in deep, and he lays it home. Brandon Walker, big time bucket at the end of the shot clock, and we're counting seconds now, 2:35 to go, MSU up 77-58. A magical defensive performance in the second half today. Moody a logo three, that's short. And Ford fighting for the rebound. Patterson dives on the floor and wins it. He gets it off to Rob Ford, and he slows it down to the right wing. Now goes to the rack, blocked from behind. Oh, and he went down hard, and he got kicked. Oh, no. Rob Ford down on the floor, holding his right hamstring. A foot by Sawyer kind of swung over and caught him in the chest. Ford helped back up. And he gives the most painful thumbs up you have ever seen. What do we got here? Timeout called by Montana. MSU has had some nightmares against the Grizzlies this season. Over in Missoula in the football game of the Brawl of the Wild, it did not go well. In Bozeman, the first meeting for Logie and DeCure, did not go well. Over in Missoula, it was a blowout on the hardwood in mid-February. But Montana State has kept the faith. They have continued to build. They have trusted the first-year head coach, Matt Logie, and this program that was risen up to new heights under Danny Sprinkle is maintaining that success with a 77-58 lead against the Montana Grizzlies with 2 minutes and 17 seconds left in the Big Sky Tournament Championship. Bobcats have made 4 of the 5 finals in Boise Big Sky Tournament history. And the Bobcats looking for just the second three-peat in Big Sky history. Weber State had one at the end of the 70s when there were only 4 teams that would make the tournament. 2.25 to go in the game. Montana State to inbound up 77-58. Into Walker. Nice catch. Walker down to the right block. Posts up. Turns. Righty. Yep. Lays it in off the glass. Brandon Walker able to finish. He comes off the bench and provides a big boost after the injury to John Olmstead. 2:05 remaining. Whistle, foul. Lekalot getting tagged away from the ball. He's frustrated by it, and Lekalot has his fourth. Know what's below. Tap, click, or call 811 before you dig. Brought to you by Montana811.org. A 19-point lead. What a second half. MSU has allowed Montana, one of the better offensive teams in the conference, to just 20 points since the halftime break. They have outscored Montana 47-20 since halftime. First free throw is good for Deshaun Thomas after the Lekolot foul. 18 points for Rob Ford, 8 rebounds, 4 assists. 16 points for John Olmstead, who's in the back getting checked out after what appeared to be a fairly painful injury. Next free throw, no good. Rob Ford tips the rebound. Sam Lekolot fighting for it. No, Montana gets it back. Moody steps to his left, hands it off. Vasquez, his three. That's good. 79-62, 155 remaining. So I think there was also foul underneath by Montana State. And it was on Eddie Turner for a push, his second. Okay, this, if you're going to give up a 21-point lead, this is how it happens. Cannot let your foot off the gas. 155 remaining in the Big Sky season. The Bobcats hunting a three-peat. Oki knocks down the front end of the 1-1. 11 points for Lalo Oki. A win today in Montana State would have the longest Big Sky tournament winning streak in conference history, eyeing a ninth straight. They haven't lost since the 2021 final against Eastern Washington. Still got to close this one out. Oki knocks down the next free throw. 12 points for Lalu Oki. MSU up 79-64, 155 remaining. Into Ford in the backcourt. He's along the right sideline. He gets out of traffic, picks up the dribble on the right wing. He's pestered and a foul. Foul by Montana. And who else? Robert Ford III going to the line. John Olmstead back out of the locker room. And he walks back to the bench. Still letting that right arm kind of hang. He is actually accepting some high fives with the right hand. That was the wrist he was holding. Doesn't look too swollen. Hopefully he's all right. Robert Ford III going to the line. Key part as the backup point guard last year. Darius Brown departs, and he was one of the massive players of the Mountain West this year. Going to Utah State. Ford on the front end. No! Oh, it was halfway down. 79-64, 145 to go. MSU leading. Montana with the ball to our right. Montana looking for their 12th tournament championship. Out to Vasquez, right corner three. That's no good. Rob Ford has the rebound. His ninth of the night. And then he draws the foul deep in the backcourt by Oki. A 1-1 for Montana State. Northwest Crossing is springing to life with brand new homes now selling by Williams Homes. Discover airy, comfortable floor plans with built-in value beginning in the 600,000s. Residents can walk to neighborhood parks, shopping, dining, and retail. Plus, you'll be close to good schools. Learn more at nwxbzn.com. Rob Ford to the line. It's a 1-1. And the free throw is good. 19 points in the title game for Robert Ford III, who's putting together an MVP resume. Already has earned first team All Big Sky. Has already earned defensive MVP in the league this year. Third straight Bobcat to do it. From Bello to Brown to Ford to that free throw falling. Montana State's offense has done everything they needed to do tonight. Up 81-64 with 135 remaining in the game. Whitney out to the right wing. Fires to Vasquez. He tries to penetrate. Gets inside. Lays it up. Yes. 81-66, 120 remaining. Lekolot running the baseline, looking to get it in. Needs some help. Ford comes back, makes the catch. He dribbles past Brandon Whitney, angles into the front court. Ford up to the top, fires into the right corner. Back out to Turner. MSU has already ended Dylan Jones' career. They ended a Cole Maywin's career last night. Today they try to end the career of Anand Moody and Brandon Whitney and Josh Vasquez and Lalu Oki, and Deshaun Thomas. Eddie Turner going to the line as the Bobcats get ready to try to close this thing out. 68 seconds to go. Turner puts it up and in. Cats did not shoot at the free throw line well to start, but like we've been saying in the context of the John Olmstead story, it's not how you start, it's how you finish. That's something that can be applied to the entire season. Turner hits the free throw. MSU getting ready to finish this off. 83-66, Cats on top, 105 remaining. Logie looking for his first win against his mentor. Travis DeCure Brandon Whitney on the drive, puts up a runner. That's good. 83-68, 58 seconds to go in the ball game. Lekalot to inbound. Given to Turner, deep in the backcourt. He's pestered by Vasquez. Trouble, and it's stolen. Vasquez takes it back and lays it in. 13-point game, 83-70, 52 seconds to go. MSU had quite a monkey on their back trying to close out games with full court pressure. Turner trapped, still pivoting. We got a whistle and a timeout called by Montana State. Their final timeout of the day. Montana State wilted under full court pressure multiple times during the regular season. Will MSU be able to handle this? Banged up, beat up, brawled out. Gracky, he's been on the bench the entire second half after going down hard, landing on his hip. John Olmstead on the bench the last couple of minutes, still flexing out that right shoulder and right wrist with a big gash on his left side of his neck. Robert Ford III somehow still standing in the 11th hour. But the Bobcats lead by 13 with 48 seconds to go. Intermountain Health, formerly known as SCL Health in Big Sky Country, is proud to be an official health partner of Montana State Athletics. Bobcat fans have been wandering in the wilderness in the early 2000s, and they have built a home in Boise in the 2020s, hunting a third straight NCAA tournament berth, eyeing their sixth all-time NCAA tournament, and potentially moments away from their fifth Big Sky Tournament championship. 49 seconds to go. Montana State is going to have to overcome what has been their final boss all year long. It was the late full court pressure by Portland State that cost the Cats that win in Portland. It was the late full court pressure by Long Beach State that cost the Cats that key win in the non-conference. Can they get past the Grizzlies' gritty full court press now and prove they're a different team today than they were in November and even in January? Montana State up by 13, 49 seconds to go. Give it in to Robert Ford. He's pestered in the backcourt. He dribbles right through it, slices through the defense, picks it up in the left wing, slings over to the right wing for Patterson, and he tosses out to Lekalot. He makes the catch, gives it to Ford. He's on the right sideline and draws the foul. Robert Ford III going to the line. Cat Country going to their feet. Montana State leading 83-70. It was not a good shooting at first half. The Bobcats couldn't get anything to fall. They were 3 of 14 from beyond the arc, yet they've found their touch here in the second half, a blistering 58% from the field. Ford buries the free throw. These are the daggers. The MVP chant breaks out. You're not wrong. It's good. Ford hits them both. Cats up by 15. 35 seconds to go in the game. Grizzlies into the front court, out to Vasquez. Takes it up to the top of the key. Vasquez into the lane. Pulls up, hands off. Picked off Rob Ford, his 100th steal of the year. And that will ice it. The Golden Bobcats continue their march. Montana State has done it. These are the good old days. Montana State wins the 2024 Big Sky Tournament Championship. It's a three-peat for the Cats. The final seconds, and here it is. Montana State wins it. Confetti flies, the ball tossed into the air. Robert Ford III, an MVP performance, and the Bobcats are three-time champs. The 2020s have been built by the Bobcats in Boise. Four finals games in Boise in the 20s. Montana State has made them all. They have won three straight, and the Bobcats now have won their ninth consecutive Big Sky Tournament game. That is the longest tournament winning streak in Big Sky Tournament history. If you didn't believe it in January, you better believe it now. Montana State has won it 85-70 against the Grizzlies. And Montana State will march on. My goodness, what an incredible year. What an incredible performance. And the Bobcats are moving on. Absolutely surreal. tears are flowing across the board. Zach Payne can't believe it. He can't get the tear out of his eyes. Julius Smith is pumping up the crowd. He's on cloud nine. And Coach Logie, as the confetti flew, turned and found his wife and parents in the stands as his eyes watered up, and the Bobcats have won the 2024 Big Sky Tournament Championship. I'd say it's unbelievable, but you gotta believe it. MSU wins it. We're taking a break. Extended coverage coming up. Montana State wins 85-70 over the Grizzlies. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
Great houses start with a sound foundation. That foundation starts with a mortgage with Sarah Kelzer and team at Guaranteed Rate. She is Bozeman's trusted mortgage specialist with 20 years experience that knows the neighborhood. We have great rates and personalized home lending solutions, and our decisions are made quickly so you can move into your dream home sooner. Guaranteed Rate, the foundation of great homes throughout Montana. Call Sarah at 406-580-6604 or apply online. Equal housing lender subject to credit approval. NMLS number 400361.
Found your dream home but dread having to move? Call Mesa Moving and Storage. We make moving fun. We work hard so you don't have to. We are here to help take the stress out of moving your home or business. If there's a move in your future, contact Mesa to handle the details so you can enjoy the experience. Mesa, the largest United Agency family in Montana, is ready to take care of all your moving and storage needs. Call the friendly folks at Mesa, 406-285-7033.
Montana Fence, located in Billings, Bozeman, Great Falls, and Kalispell, is Montana's largest fencing superstore. Get everything you need for your fencing projects at rock-bottom pricing. Low prices on all styles of farm fence. Chain link, vinyl privacy, ornamental iron, cedar pickets, continuous panels, wood privacy. We have it all. Quality materials at truckload prices. Let the experts at Montana Fence help you plan your next project. Whether you use our team or do it yourself, check out Montana Fence.
Bobcat fans, support both your favorite team and Montana State students. When you shop at MSU Bookstores, you help lower the price of course materials for Montana State students. MSU Bookstore is owned by MSU students and faculty and serves as the only not-for-profit campus bookstore in Montana. Shop online at msubookstore.org, at Bobcat Stadium on game days, or on campus in the Strand Union Building. Remember, Bobcat fans, when you shop at MSU Bookstore, all proceeds from your purchase go directly to lowering the cost of course materials for Montana State students.
Join Town Pump's Pump It Up Rewards Plus program and never pay full price for fuel again.
Save 5 cents on every gallon every day at any Town Pump across Montana.
Plus, earn and redeem points on your favorite in-store items to get free stuff with our clubs.
Stop in and pick up a rewards card. Download the Pump It Up Rewards Plus app today.
Or visit townpump.com/rewards to register and start saving.
Northern States Fishing Tools, a proud sponsor of the Montana State Bobcats, has been serving the eastern Montana and western North Dakota oil fields since 1978. We are here to provide you with the best tools and services, all at competitive prices. Northern States Fishing Tools services the Williston Basin with fishing and rental tools, along with downhole tools that include packers, plugs, and through-tubing equipment. We have the expert knowledge to give you satisfying results based on your specific needs. Go Bobcats!
Bobcat Basketball has been brought to you by Bridger Brewing. Cheers to every journey being better than the last. Door Tech, raising the door on quality. Montana State University, mountains and mines. And by Prime Lending, home loans made simple. Equal housing lender. Live from the First Interstate Bank broadcast booth, this is Bobcat Postgame.
Better believe it, Montana State, the three-peat. Back-to-back-to-back Big Sky champs. Montana State takes down the arch rival, 85-70 over Montana. Yes, the brawl has been filled with heartbreak this year, but not tonight, and Montana State wins it. They get an MVP performance from Robert Ford III, and the Bobcats are victorious today as they will head back to an NCAA tournament for a sixth time in program history. And the third consecutive time, Robert Ford taking a moment and just soaking it all in. It was Rob Ford who would not let this team celebrate in the locker room this week. He was all business. Logie even tried to help this team celebrate after the semifinals last night, and Rob said no, absolutely not. This is all business. We've got work to do, and he has finished that work tonight with a Big Sky championship. Rob Ford in the championship game, 22 points, 9 rebounds, and it was his steal that clinched it. It was his 100th steal of the year. And Montana State will finish the regular season and the tournament season with a 17-17 record. Go all the way back to last year, and Montana State lost Darius Brown, who's all-conference in the Mountain West. They lost Great Osabor, who was newcomer and player of the year in the Mountain West, and Danny Sprinkle, the coach of the year in the Mountain West, the outright champs at Utah State. And Montana State lost all of that to come back and earn a 15-point win in the championship game today. A surreal ride continues for Montana State, and the Bobcats win it 85-70 over the Grizzlies. We'll see what the awards are, the postseason awards. We'll get some coaches and players on here at some point, but the guys are all hanging out now underneath the big scoreboard at center court. The blue and white confetti is strewn across the floor. Everybody's got their white Big Sky Championship hats on. Rob Ford is limping right now. I don't know how you're standing, man. What an effort by Robert Ford III. The Bobcats have won it. They've got their championship hats and shirts on that read, "Let's Dance 2024 Big Sky Champs." MSU winning 85-70. Tyler Patterson with the big shots. Sam Lekalot, a massive smile on his face right now. And MSU has won it 85-70. They defeat the Grizzlies. They've only met twice in the championship, and Montana State has found a way to beat Montana in both instances. We are joined now by Sheridan Sam. Sam Lekalot. Sam, congratulations. You hear me okay?
Oh, yeah, we're good.
Sam, why did this team have the belief after you lost all that you did to come back and put together a run like this?
I'll be completely honest. A couple weeks ago, it was looking real rough, and it's just the leadership that we have on this team with Robert Ford and Coach Logie. I mean, without these guys, I don't think we could be here right now. And so really just the positive attitudes that they have. I mean, obviously our focus is attitude, but just having that belief no matter what. I mean, we lost to an NAIA team.
In November.
And we're probably the first to ever go to March Madness like that. And so that just tells you right there that anything can happen. If you just stick to it day by day, pay that rent, it's you. Look what happens.
Yes, sir. The confetti is flying. You guys are getting used to it here in Boise. Take me back to when they first hired Coach Logie. Why did you have such belief in him when he was one of the main candidates for this job?
You know, when he walked into that BAC, he was just a completely different person. You could just tell he was composed. He knew how to win, and obviously his record, but he's just that type of guy that he just has that confidence and swagger, and that people obviously follow him. And once again, I said his record, but it doesn't lie. And so winning like this, yeah, we were 7-17, but hey, it's March.
Yes, sir, and you get more games here in March. Finally, how sweet is it to do it against the Grizzlies in a game like this?
It's amazing. It's too good.
Sam, congratulations. Thank you for your effort and hard work today. Go enjoy the rest of the celebration. We're still dancing, baby.
Thank you. Go Cats, Bobcat Nation!
2020, the decade of the Bobcats.
Woo!
Sam Lekalot, what a performance, what a win. Montana State wins it 85-70 over the Grizzlies, and they are dancing on to the NCAA tournament. We appreciate Sam Lekalot, who was absolutely key down the stretch here as, again, Montana State is going to the NCAA tournament. You heard it from Sam. They lost to an NAIA school in November. They blew some major leads down the stretch in this season, and yet Montana State was able to find a way to continue to believe, and head coach Matt Logie keeps this incredible era alive for Montana State. They've got the ladder placed now underneath the rim and basket to our left. They've got the Big Sky Championship placard up on the backboard sitting there, and they're going to climb the ladder now, and they are going to be cutting it down the nets. Montana State gets it done, and they win it today 85 to 70 in the Big Sky Tournament Championship, and it's just an electrifying win for Montana State. Colin McGettigan, a big part of it, the director of basketball ops, and we're joined now by John Olmstead, one of the great stories of the year. John, congratulations on the win. You're going dancing with the Bobcats, and you were one of the key components. First of all, how you feeling? I know it was a big tumble at the end there. You all right there?
You know, I'm still feeling a little hurt, but, you know, we got a week to rest now. We'll be good for next week.
Going through what you did and coming out the other side like this, just staying and waiting, how much sweeter does a moment like this feel like that?
Man, it's amazing. You know, can't really put these feelings into words right now. It's crazy. It's a little bit surreal, you know. But, you know, just happy as can be for me and all my guys.
When you guys had lost some of the toughest games of the year, why did you have the belief the next day to come back, go to work, and put together a run like this?
You know, we always knew we had something special, and it just took a little bit of time to be able to find it and dig it out. Like I said, before, new program, new coach, new everything, you know, it took a little bit to get everyone on the same page. But, you know, as you can see us now, we're kind of clicking right now, so it's good.
Great time to click. John, appreciate the time. Congratulations. Can't wait to see you play at least one more game.
Thank you.
All right, John Olmstead, congratulations on the Big Sky Tournament Championship. They're about to announce the tournament awards. We'll tell you about those in a moment. We've got more coverage coming up. Montana State has won the Big Sky Tournament Championship. MSU wins it 85-70 over the Grizzlies, and the Bobcats are dancing once again. It's a three-peat for Montana State. We're taking a break, coming back after this timeout. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
Working from home has definitely put home projects into overdrive. New landscaping, gardens, patios, and fences. But if you're digging, you're contacting 811. Utility lines, including Northwestern Energy's, can be buried even just a few inches underground, and hitting one can be dangerous. The best way to keep you, the community, and your contractor crew safe is by having lines properly marked. Make your request online at least 2 full business days before you want to dig at call811.com.
Ready to build your brand? Think Inc. outside the box for your complete branding solutions. Located in Bozeman, Montana, we offer a full print shop for banners, signs, wraps, trade show booths and graphics, promotional products, and much more. If you can think it, we can ink it. We are a proud supporter and corporate sponsor of the MSU Bobcats. Like us on Facebook to see some of our cat wraps. Ready to build your brand? Think Inc. and call us at 406-922-6462 or visit us on the web at InkOutside.com.
Are you too hot? Are you too cold? Did you know that you don't have to just deal with it? We at Ambient Air Solutions understand how important comfort plays on your emotions, health, and quality of life on a daily basis. Ambient Air Solutions offers 24/7 emergency service for residential and commercial clients. We also offer financing to help ease the financial stress and burden of a lifelong investment. Call Ambient Air Solutions at 406-577-1818 and leave it to the professionals. Ambient Air Solutions, simplifying heating and cooling.
Bridger Brewing is home to award-winning locally crafted beer and pizza and is proud to support all things Bobcat sports. Open 11 a.m. to 9 p.m. daily, last beer served at 8 p.m., and located right across from the Brick Breeden Fieldhouse. Stop by after the game today to enjoy a cold pint of beer and a slice of made-from-scratch delicious pizza. Dine-in service and online ordering for takeout are both available. Check out BridgerBrewing.com and at Bridger Brewing on Instagram and Facebook, and stay tuned for updates on our newest adventure in Three Forks, Montana.
We're with the victorious head coach, Matt Logie. Montana State wins it 85-70 over the Grizzlies. Coach, as you guys were dribbling it out right before the confetti flew, you turned and looked into the crowd. What was going through your mind in that moment?
Family. You know, it's at the core of everything I believe about this sport and being a part of a team. And it started with my grandfather when I was young, and I got into coaching to pay it forward. You can't do this without a supportive family, my wife, my kids, my parents. It's just surreal.
How sweet is this? How high up is this in terms of the greatest moments of your coaching career?
Oh, it's at the top. I mean, there's just there's no way to describe what this journey's been like for these players and for our staff. I mean, you take over a program like Montana State coming off the success that they've had, you know, you've got to come in there and really believe in yourself, you know, and have no fear of failure, because the expectations are high. And we found a bunch of coaches and a bunch of players that wanted to take on that challenge. And the community support, the administrative support has just been special as we worked through this year to grow to this point. I can't say enough.
What did you say to Robert Ford III when you hugged him after the final horn sound?
I love you. I love you. He has, you know, put this team on his back from an identity perspective, and you know, nobody believed this could happen except for the guys in our family. And yeah, special.
Was he the one keeping you guys from celebrating in the locker room last night to try to finish this job?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, nobody was trying to celebrate. You know, the job wasn't done. And, you know, you don't come to a place like Montana State to not compete for championships. And so, you know, we had 24 more hours to prep.
Hey, your reward, you get another ball game, Coach.
That's right.
All right, Head Coach Matt Logie, congratulations.
Thanks. Go Cats.
All right, we're taking a break of the Raven Chop House postgame show. Montana State has won it 85-70 over the Grizzlies, and they are going dancing. Ain't no dust on these Bobcats dancing shoes as they are going to a third consecutive NCAA tournament. Montana's Rib and Chop House has been serving Rocky Mountain communities for over 20 years. Our ability to grow has come through our commitment to Rocky Mountain hospitality, a concept which incorporates a casual attitude with our commitment to loyalty, safety, service, and quality food. We hope you'll be our guest at one of our Montana locations soon. We're taking a break. More to come. Montana State is the 2024 Big Sky Tournament champs. They have completed a three-peat, just the second one ever in Big Sky history. We're taking a break again. More to come. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball presented by Learfield.
The Rib and Chop House was founded in 2001. Our ability to grow has come through our commitment to Rocky Mountain hospitality, a concept which incorporates a casual attitude with our high-level commitment to loyalty, safety, service, and quality food. At the Rib and Chop House, our staff is dedicated to creating extraordinary experiences that raise the bar in each of our communities. Enjoy premium steaks, fresh seafood, and award-winning baby back ribs. We look forward to sharing a little Rocky Mountain hospitality with you.
At Prime Lending, our one-of-a-kind mortgage approach combines a personal touch with just enough technology to turn a traditionally complex process into something better. Think of us like your home buying coach, friend, cheerleader, and teammate, all in one. From application to closing, we are your home loan partners that have your back every step of the way. Reach out to your local Prime Lending team to experience a home loan made simple. All loans subject to credit approval, rates and fees subject to change. Prime Lending, a Plains Capital Company, NMLS 13649, Equal Housing Lender.
For over 100 years, Bozeman Health has provided quality health care in Southwest Montana. With locations in Bozeman, Belgrade, and Big Sky, no matter who you are, where you are, or what you do, Bozeman Health is always there as your partner in health and wellness. Bozeman Health, proud healthcare provider of Bobcat student athletes. Visit bozemanhealth.org for more information.
Universal Athletic has been a proud supporter of Bobcat Athletics for over 45 years. Check out their great selection of Bobcat apparel and accessories for all your game day needs. Shop in store at their North 7th Avenue location or online at shop.msubobcats.com for everything you need to cheer on your Bobcats. Universal Athletic, a proud supporter of Bobcat Athletics for over 45 years. Go Cats!
Here's to home. Here's to Northwest Crossing, where kids can be kids, and adults can also be kids, and new neighbors feel like old friends. Welcome to Bozeman, Montana's newest master-planned community. Life here comes with nearby, top-rated Bozeman schools, on-site eateries and retail, office space, parks, trails, and so much more, including new homes from the 500s to 800s, exclusively built by Williams Homes. Learn more at nwxbzn.com. nwxbzn.com.
Like most Montana parents, I disapprove of teens using marijuana.
ParentingMontana.org has information for me to learn about Montana's marijuana laws.
For example, it's illegal for someone under the age of 21 to possess or consume marijuana unless they are a medical marijuana card holder.
I also use ParentingMontana.org to establish our family's rules about marijuana and help my teen manage peer pressure.
ParentingMontana.org, tools for your child's success.
Brought to you by SAMHSA and Montana DPHHS.
Back of the Rib and Chop House postgame show, Montana State is dancing. They win it 85-70 over the rival in 12 all-time postseason tournament meetings against Montana. MSU is now 6-6. They won in 09 after losing both regular season games. They win today after losing both regular season games. And the golden era of Bobcat basketball goes on. At Montana's Ribbon Chop House, our staff is dedicated to creating extraordinary experiences that raise the bar in each of our communities. Enjoy premium steaks, fresh seafood, and award-winning baby back ribs. We look forward to sharing a little Rocky Mountain hospitality with you. Well, we'll see where Montana State goes for the NCAA tournament. We knew that it's not going to be a great seed. There's a really good chance Montana State ends up as a 16 seed. They could end up in the first four. There's actually a pretty high likelihood that Montana State's in the first four. Probably going to see them in Dayton. But if they are a 16 seed, then that means they would be playing another 16 seed, which would be great because that would give you a prime opportunity to win an NCAA tournament game. And Montana State now with 9 straight wins in Big Sky tournament play, and it is the longest winning streak in the Big Sky tournament ever. And the Cats have done it today, and they have won now 10 games in the tournament in the last 3 years. 11, make it 11. They're 11-1 since 2021. That is 11 of their 27 wins ever in the tournament. They're now 27-31 in the Big Sky tournament as they win their 5th tournament title today. And you know, it's even a little sweeter when you get to do it against those other guys from the other side of the hill. Montana State winning it today, and we will get a few more players on here if we can as Montana State is victorious. All right, let's pause 10 seconds for our network station identification. You're listening to Montana State Basketball.
AM 1450 KMMS, Bozeman. 1340 KPRK Livingston, where Montana talks.
Keaton Gillogly with you, Trevor Nominuk back in the studios, and Montana State celebrating in a sea of confetti on the Idaho Central Arena floor. Montana State has had unbelievable success here. They have won 3 of the 5 tournaments in Boise since the tournament moved here in 2019. Of course, no tournament in 2020 due to the coronavirus pandemic. Everybody's celebrating, taking pictures. They have not cut down the nets yet. Everybody's got their championship hats on. Robert Ford III is officially the MVP, and Brian Garacki also named to the all-tournament team today as well with the Bobcats. Somehow, they're 17-17 now. They were 14-17 coming into the tournament, and the Bobcats have found a way to get it done, and they are dancing. Everybody taking pictures now, interviews happening on the floor, fans are on the floor now getting an opportunity to interact with everybody. One fan is making snow angels or confetti angels right now, and they are doing some impressive work. Some of the numbers from the victory today, Montana State led once again by Robert Ford III, 22 points, 9 rebounds, 4 assists. 16 points for John Olmstead, 5 rebounds, 5 of 7 from the field, 6 of 8 from the free throw line. Eddie Turner was just so instrumental in this game, 15 points, 6 of 16, 3 assists in the contest as well. Brandon Walker, 14 points, 6 rebounds. Tyler Patterson, 12 points, 2 rebounds. In 2 of his 3 Big Sky Tournament Championship games, he scored in double figures, and he was key down the stretch. Lekalot 3, Garacki at 3. He got hurt late but did come back out on the bench. MSU shoots 50% from the field, 6 of 23 from the three-point line, 15 of 22 from the free throw line. Grizzlies 45% from the field, 33% from downtown, 73% from the free throw line today. Vasquez led the way with 20 points. Moody at 14. Oki at 14. Whitney at 13. Thomas had 9. That was it. So only 5 guys scored for Montana today while the Bobcats really spread it out. They, on the glass, were only minus 2, 34-32 against Montana. Remember, it was the rebounding battle that was a big part of the loss in Missoula earlier this year. But the Bobcats get it done. So MSU as the 5 seed, they win the title. Not the first time they've done something like that as one of the lower seeds, but they get it done today, and Montana State wins it by 15. They absolutely blitzed this Montana team in the second half, and the Bobcats have gotten it done today, and they are victorious. All right, they are getting ready to start cutting down some of the net. Montana State gets the victory today, and somehow, some way, they get the victory, and man, from wandering in the desert for years and years and years. You think back to all those years when Montana State was just hoping to win a tournament game. It was 19 years where they had won only three tournament games, and now they have won three tournament games in back-to-back-to-back years. That's three straight Big Sky Tournament championships, and Montana State wins it. We'll take another break. We'll see if we can get another player or two as Montana State wins it. We have the selection show coming up on Sunday. That's going to be at 3 o'clock Mountain Time as MSU wins it by 15. We'll take a break. More of the Ribbon Chop House postgame show after this. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball presented by Learfield.
From our 1946 roots, providing lumber for Yellowstone National Park, to our current headquarters in Bozeman, we at Simpkins Hallen believe in building the Gallatin Valley's future while continuing to honor its past. Contractors large and small benefit from our decades of experience and our extensive network of suppliers. We can source the materials you need, no matter the project. For all your building needs, go to where longstanding traditions have met with quality building products for over 75 years. Simpkins Hallen, a Montana tradition among builders since 1946.
It was a nice spring day, so I decided to do a little work around the house. I didn't think anything of it. I've dug 1,000 holes 1,000 times, until I hit a shallow gas line. The repair cost me over $5,000, and in one fell swoop, the family vacation was kaput. I know I'm not the only one, but it still hurts. Next time I'm calling 811 before I dig.
Learn from Jerry and hundreds of others. Call 811 before you dig.
Brought to you by Montana811.org.
At Firehouse Subs, a portion of every purchase helps provide much-needed life-saving equipment to first responders across the country. That's why at Firehouse Subs, they make their subs differently, because their subs can make a difference. Their family of restaurant owners and local crews are proud to continue to serve you the hot, hearty, life-saving subs you crave every day. In fact, it's never been easier to grab their subs to go with Rapid Rescue to go. Save time when you order online at firehousesubs.com or on their app. Firehouse Subs. Enjoy more subs. Save more lives.
Town and Country Foods is a proud supporter of Bobcat Athletics. As a locally owned company, we believe the benefit of buying local helps support the local economies in Southwest Montana. Our stores offer great selections of items you need every day, including organics, specialty foods, fresh meats and produce, along with incredible selections from our bakery and deli departments. Town and Country Foods is 100% employee owned and serves Southwest Montana with 8 locations. Visit your local Town and Country Foods today. Go Cats!
Montana State wins it 85-70 over Montana. They are the Big Sky Tournament champs today, and the Big Sky Tournament MVP is Robert Ford III, and he joins us now on the postgame show. Rob, congratulations. Hey, how you feeling? You did not look like you were walking perfectly at the end of this.
Honestly, sore. Everything hurts, but I'll be fine.
Tell me about the mentality of these last two games. I heard that you were not letting this team celebrate in the locker room last night. Is that true?
I mean, we understand that it's a business trip. We came in, and I kind of said that the first time we won, and we just had it going. You know, when I put the sticker on, I just kind of kept it business orientated, and they wanted to keep it that way. And we said, you know, let's enjoy this, but we know what's at stake, and we know, you know, where we want to be when this is all said and done.
Why did you guys have the belief to go through the lows you had to reach the highest of highs now?
I'll give you one example. In our huddle, our guard huddle, Our coach talked to us. He said, you know, this is what the whole season was about. But when you guys go to sleep tonight, let's not regret and say, oh, we left something out there. He said, give it all you got. And I feel like we came out and we did that.
What were you thinking about when they named you as the Big Sky MVP today?
I wasn't thinking at all. I was hurting, sore, and I was just happy to help my team win, to be honest.
Yeah, we're really happy for you. Congratulations. What a win. Final question. Why was Matt Logie able to keep this team together? Why was he the guy to be able to push you guys to a championship?
He just has great poise. You know, he told us, he, you know, broke it down, and, you know, at the end of the game, he said it's poise. And that's a great way to, you know, describe him. He's great, man.
Is it a little special, sweeter to do it against the Grizzlies?
Hey, man, it is. I can't even lie. It is.
Yes, sir. Hey,
they're a really great team,
of course.
But we're glad, you know, to get a win.
But you don't have to play them again, so you can't give them any bulletin board material.
Yeah, you're right. Wow, it was the last one ever. I didn't think about that. Man.
But you know what? It wasn't. It was not your last game ever. You get
yes,
at
sir.
Least one more.
Yes, sir.
You ready to go dancing?
One at a time.
Congratulations, Rob. On behalf of all Bobcat Country. Congratulations.
Thank you.
All right. Robert Ford III, a champion in every right. Truly Bobcat built. Montana State wins it 85-70. All right, we're going to take one more break. When we get back, we'll get you the player of the game. We will get you some highlights, and we will wrap it up as Montana State is cutting down the nets right now in Idaho. A three-peat for the Bobcats. Sam Lekalot holding onto the trophy, holding it up above his head, and nothing but blue and white confetti strewn all across the floor here in Idaho. More of the Ribbon Chop House postgame show coming up. Montana State wins the 2024 Big Sky Tournament Championship with an 85-70 win against those guys from the other side of the hill. They defeat the Grizzlies in the title game. We're back after this. You're listening to Bobcat Basketball presented by Learfield.
The Ribbon Chop House was founded in 2001. Our ability to grow has come through our commitment to Rocky Mountain hospitality, a concept which incorporates a casual attitude with our high-level commitment to loyalty, safety, service, and quality food. At the Ribbon Chop House, our staff is dedicated to creating extraordinary experiences that raise the bar in each of our communities. Enjoy premium steaks, fresh seafood, and award-winning baby back ribs. We look forward to sharing a little Rocky Mountain hospitality with you.
World-class physicians, patient care that's second to none, the most advanced technology available. With a scorecard like that, you can trust Vance Thompson Vision to provide you with the best possible options for your vision. From LASIK to cataracts to everything in between, our surgeons and their teams root for their patients with as much dedication as diehard fans do for their favorite teams. Request your laser vision consultation from the official LASIK and cataract surgeon of the Bobcats. Visit VanceThompsonVision.com.
At Prime Lending, our one-of-a-kind mortgage approach combines a personal touch with just enough technology to turn a traditionally complex process into something better. Think of us like your home buying coach, friend, cheerleader, and teammate all in one. From application to closing, we are your home loan partners that have your back every step of the way. Reach out to your local Prime Lending team to experience a home loan made simple. All loans subject to credit approval, rates and fees subject to change. Prime Lending, a Plains Capital Company, NMLS 13649, Equal Housing Lender.
What's in a name? For some, the meaning runs deeper than the word we see in front of us. There's a history to it. We are Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Montana. And the biggest part of our name will always be the smallest, of. Because it's the of that connects us, which means we are of our communities, of a promise passed down for a healthier tomorrow through it all.
Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Montana, a division of Healthcare Service Corporation, a mutual legal reserve company.
You are a Bobcat fan, and your seat matters. Section 108, right in the middle, and a perfect view of the fast break, alley-oop, and slam dunk. At Kendall Ford of Bozeman, we're a supporter of Montana State Athletics. We're big fans of teamwork, dedication, and helping customers find the best deal on the perfect vehicle to fit their needs. Where you sit matters, as in the driver's seat. Get started at KendallFordBozeman.com. Kendall, let's start something great.
The Northern Pulse Growers Association encourages industry professionals and growers of dry peas, chickpeas, lentils, and fava beans to become members in 2024. Members gain access to cutting-edge research, expert training, market insights, and connect with a Pulse-passionate community. Visit NorthernPulse.com to join the Northern Pulse Growers Association. Together, we're sowing the seeds of success.
Back one final time of the postgame show, but not one final time on the year. Montana State has won the Big Sky Tournament Championship. It's a three-peat for the Cats, and they do it against the arch rivals, 85-70. They defeat the Grizzlies tonight, and it is all written in blue and gold in Boise once again. Wanted Cruzado, the president of the university, gets the net necklace, and then she hands it back to Coach Logie. And everybody is celebrating now. All right, we got more to get to, so up next, let's go to our highlights. Let's listen to our first Security Bank highlights of the game now as Montana State has earned the victory today. So, again, let's catch those highlights right now.
Robert Ford fires into the corner. Karacki for three. Yes. Deshaun Thomas at the top. Pivoting. Fires and picked. Robert Ford with a steal, whistled a foul on Anand Moody. Olmstead had the contest, and Lekalot had the rebound. He throws ahead. Olmstead cherry-picking, two-hand jam. Timeout, Montana. Missed it right. Rebound tip. Lekalot won it. Beat Deshaun Thomas for it. MSU gets another crack at it. Turner to his right. Alley-oop. Olmstead makes the catch and jams it home. Patterson back to Olmstead, five. He gives it to Ford, four. He tries to contest it, three, and drills it. Pulls up at the free throw line. Kicks it out. Lekalot, right wing three. Book it. Hand off for Ford. Bounce pass to Walker. Steps in, lays it. Good and one. Just Ford to the right corner. He's open. His three ball. Yes! Turner. Reverse layup is good. Off the window. Eddie Turner, the third. Turner into the lane. Gets underneath. Kicks to Patterson. Right corner three. Bang! Vasquez into the lane. Pulls up. Hands off. Picked off Rob Ford. His 100th steal of the year. And that will ice it. The Golden Bobcats continue their march. Montana State has done it.
There it is. Those are the first Security Bank highlights of the game, and Montana State has earned the victory. They defeat the Grizzlies 85-70. All right, the selection show is coming up on Sunday, so it'll be a St. Patrick's Day selection show, which will be fun. That'll be at 3 o'clock coming up again on Sunday, so that's what's up next for the Bobcats. It's not over yet for Montana State. They are one of the lower net teams in the country, so I would not be surprised if we see a 16 seed here for Montana State. But that's something that we get to worry about on Sunday, and it was the 100th steal of Robert Ford's season that clinches the three-peat for Montana State. What an incredible way to end it. All right, some of the business to get to now for Montana State, the Intermountain Health Player of the Game, easily presented to Robert Ford III. What an effort by Rob today, 22 points, 9 rebounds, 4 assists, and another 5 steals. He had another 2 3-point field goals today. 15 straight games with multiple threes for Robert Ford now, and he finishes the regular season and tournament with 100 steals, one of the great defensive seasons in Big Sky history as Montana State gets the victory. The McDonald's delivery of the game presented by a locally owned and operated McDonald's of Montana for the Bobcats. Eddie Turner was doing nothing but delivering alley-oop slams to John Olmstead. It was incredible what he was doing in the first half and early in the second, and Montana State pulls away, and they end the season and career of Anand Moody. The Bobcats get the victory today, 85-70, a magical ride that's not done yet. All right, thank you to everybody who joined us, Rob and Sam and Coach Logie, who have jumped on with us today. Really appreciate their insight and their effort and hard work all season long. Thank you to everybody who's been a part of the broadcast this year, and we've got more coming as well. Again, the selection show is on Sunday at 3 o'clock, and we'll find out where we're going from there. Wouldn't be surprised if we end up seeing Montana State in that first four. They're going to probably be a 16 seed, considering that they are 223 in the net right now. So they're going to be down there. But we'll see what happens. So, again, Montana State gets the victory, and we've got at least one more game in the NCAA tournament. All right, well, that will wrap it all up. This is Keaton Gillogly saying so long. To say it's been a pleasure would be an understatement, but we are so happy that you have been a part of this journey through the highs and through the lows, and thank you to all of Cat Country who has showed up and showed out through thick and thin, and today you have been rewarded with a third straight title. Final score for a final time in the Big Sky Tournament Final. Montana State wins it 85-70 over Montana, and the Bobcats are marching on, and the Cats are going into the locker room now, and they will have a moment with their teammates and truly be able to celebrate what has been an historic run. Thanks again for tuning in. You've been listening to Bobcat Basketball, presented by Learfield.
Bobcat Basketball has been brought to you by Town Pump Food Stores, proud sponsor of the Brawl of the Wild Series. Guaranteed Rate, the foundation of great homes throughout Montana. And by